Good evening, good morning, good afternoon. Welcome. We are back. Now you might notice that the camera quality is a little bit higher quality. That's because I've changed some settings in OBS to use a different resolution. So it should look a little bit better now, which is nice. So we are once again playing some Angels with Scaly Wings. Okay, so I have to shout out my sponsors. Of course, Bryce's Diary, I mean chocolate milk. We have some cheap ass bullet energy drink. And of course, due to you guys recommending it to me, of course, beer. In this case, Heineken. So I got all that by my side. We should be good with that. So we're gonna dive straight into the game. Tonight we are doing Anna's Route. One of Anna's Routes, which should be interesting. Apparently. Okay, there we go. So, oh god, people are talking about stuff again and I can't click out of it. There we go. Okay, we're... No, that's gonna freeze again. Okay, so we are going to start again. Another route. Continue your journey, MetallicCore. Yes, we shall. Bum. Oh, look, there's a trauma card. I haven't seen that one before. That's interesting. So many proud sponsors of dragon dating. Yeah. Anna! No, N-A, I think. Okay, tab. This stream was sponsored by Night Sky? I mean, technically speaking, it was. Okay, I don't want to skip ahead. We're gonna tap. Tab. He looks grumpy. I mean, we've already seen all of this. It was not? No! He bought me the game, so technically speaking, it is sponsored by him. If it wasn't for him, I might not have gotten the game. I was thinking about it, but I wasn't sure if I was. So, you can have my blood, dragoness. Let me see, that's it, yes. No. No security. Tab. There's the copy. Tab. Thanks. Nice of you. Then we have Lorem. Stream is stucks. Oh fuck, it is. Why? Oh, and now Angel was... Now the game is crashed. Motherfucker. Now the game is just crashed. 0 out of 10. Oh, shut the fuck. God damn it. Technical difficulties, sorry guys. Fun. Shut up! I can't help it. Yeah, the game is stuck on stream. Okay, good thing that nothing interesting was being shown. Dislike? Wow, rude. Oh, and I didn't even get to save! Fuck! Okay, trauma. Yep, dislike? Okay. Well, seems like I'll have to start drinking early tonight. I mean, because y'all being so fucking rude, I mean, I gotta get some alcohol in my system. Eh. Fuck, I fucking... Drop the thing! There it is. By the way, I got this, I actually got this, this bottle opener from my work. Yeah. They're actually promoting alcoholism at my job. Which is interesting, since we work with old people. So that is rather interesting. In any case, cheers. Okay, so we're gonna tap through all this. Shake the fucker's hat, skip. Sure. Both are just come and go. Skip. No. Skip. Around security. Okay. Skip. Skip. Copy. Just grab my tinfoil hat. Skip. Charming fellow. Thanks. Skip. How nice of you. I've done this many times now. Holy fuck. I have work? Listen up here. I am a responsible fucking adult, okay? I have work. Come on. Rude. Okay, look elsewhere. Bro, Angel with Scaly Wings player. I played through the game in 10 minutes. Metalcore, I got the game starting after 10 minutes. Pretty much. Okay, skip. Look in the kitchen. Look in the pantry. Lemon. Skip. Not really pro since you aren't reading everything. I mean, I have read this. I could have read this like three times now. I would have read this like three times now. I ain't got time for that shit. They fucking, these routes take long enough. Well, guess I did. Skip. Spit it out already. Whatever. Skip. Skip. Yes, I will help you. Skip, just do it. Flicked it with a sharp implement. Well, could have only been someone with hands. Child labor is outlawed in the EU, you know, so no work for you. Listen, motherfucker, I am 19, okay? I am not a child. Fuck off. I am not a fucking child, okay? Jesus. Rude. Well, didn't want to make any noise. One on his neck. Tab. Oh, he died here. Skip. Bought back. Skip. I have a name, you know? Seen with a lot of people get the bad angle on the first playthrough of the game. I think that's kind of done intentionally. Yeah. Skip. So we find him. Skip. Okay, here we go. Now we're getting into new territory. This we have never done before. Okay, Anna. Hello, Anna. She told me to meet her here, so she's got to be around somewhere. The production facility had many different wings, covering everything from research to processing, in addition to production. It was easy to get lost if you didn't know where you were going. I heard some commotion in the distance, and when I approached, I was surprised to see not only Anna, but Remy as well. Chuck Norris got the ultimate ending. Yeah, he saved everything and everyone. He jumped into space and just fucking... Rah! He just punched the fucking comet. Fucking amazing. Can't get it, Elder. You cannot get it unless you are Chuck Norris. Oh, Remy is here as well? Dude, I have seen Remy everywhere in this game. Now I am really fucking interested in his fucking route. They seemed to be in the middle of a heated conversation. I thought it would be inappropriate to approach now, so I remained several paces back, out of their field of vision, but still close enough to be able to make out their words. Goddamn late again? You are not late, we have only just gotten started. We have heard the rumors. So you come to me on basis of rumors? Is that how you operate? What do you want from me? This is not the first time you've been in trouble, you know. They might not be so lenient with you this time. I don't know what you're talking about. Consider this a warning. You should proceed carefully, for your own good. If you wanted to threaten me, the least you could have done was to send someone more intimidating. You may be larger than I am, but even I can see that you're just a big coward. You wouldn't dare put your dirty claws on me. Damn, girl's got a mouth on her. Fuck. I wouldn't. I'm here as a courtesy to you, not to threaten or intimidate. Do with that information whatever you wish. You just woke up? Pfft, I wish. You know we'll be back, and if they find anything, there will be consequences. Well, good morning to you, by the way. Do you think I care? This attitude of yours is not helpful. 2 p.m.? Dude, I am really jealous of you right now, you know that? Neither are you. Well, I've said what I came here to say. Good luck. Whatever. Remy is just... Remy's going after everyone and the fucker just can't catch a break. Like I said, I am really interested in his route now. Because this smoker has hands in everything. Remy turned to leave and started walking in my direction. I ducked behind a pillar and he went past. I wasn't sure if he'd seen me. Either way, he left, and I was safe to approach now. Well, hey Anna. Hey Metalcore. And yet the red telephone would be in Anna's claws in a better place than Trump's hands? Wow. Wait, how long have you been there? Well, not very long. Not that it matters much anyway. This is just par of the course for me. I know Remy. What's the problem? The nerve of that guy! He probably wouldn't be so uptight if it wasn't for that thing with his girlfriend a few years ago. Ugh. But I don't care about him. It's his peers that are the problem. They don't like me and the research I'm doing. They cite their traditions and values, claiming that those are what have kept us alive for so long. If anything were to change, it would obviously fracture the base this society is built on, causing it all to collapse, tear apart families, and allow all hell to break loose. Jump onto Remy? Not yet. Not yet. Later. At least if you believe those old-timers who keep repeating these phrases. Yeah, the conservatives. I mean, keeping to tradition is fine, but you gotta move on eventually. And all that nonsense, because of my research. Valuable research that could save lives, mind you. What kind of research are we talking about? I could show you sometime, but we're here to have fun, right? And play Angry Dragon Rodeo? Oh, that would be glorious. Just jump on Maverick's back, just like, yeehaw! I thought you wanted to show me, since you said we were both in biology and all that. Sure, but after having to do this all day, you'll have to excuse me for not wanting to talk about it even more. Wasting my time with that guy was just another setback. Not that I don't already have more than enough work to do. Even right now, I'm supposed to be working overtime. Huh. You guys were like, okay, do the opposite of what you would do. So, that would be this, basically. Oh, shit. I feel like that wasn't a good idea. I have a bad feeling he's going to have a bad time. Yeah, I'm very sorry we can't accommodate your request right now, Your Highness. Oh, and thanks for the blood, by the way. The results aren't in yet, but I'll let you know when they are. Good. I'm just as curious about the results as you are. No, you aren't. I am way curiouser than you are. Curiouser? Is that even a word? No, it's not. It is, since an author popularized it, it's used where I came from. Then I am way more curiouser than you are. Not if I am the curiousest. People, stop! Excuse me for a moment, but I must weep for the English language. At this rate, why don't you just say you're the most curiouserest? Oh, glorious. We're arguing language with a dragon. I'm not sure. I'm not a linguist. Are you? Not exactly, but I have a way with words. My tongue is quite skilled, or so I hear. Oh, really? Some might even say cunning. Oh, this is a total slut. Holy fuck. At least she's not a fucking prude. In any case, if you have to work overtime today, does that mean I should wait for you, or do you want me to come back another time? Is a hobby linguist? Neither. I think my break should start right about now. What a lucky coincidence. It is, isn't it? So, where are we going? I don't know where you're going, but I think I need a coffee or five. You can tag along if you like. Well, sure. Now that's a convincing reason. She must be from the SS then? Oh god, are we going into this territory? I hope you brought your own money though, because I'm not sharing. I didn't, but everything I purchased is taken care of by my ambassador status. Nice. Actually, that opens up some very interesting possibilities. Oh really? Grammar Nazi? It might, but I'd rather not do anything too fishy. I don't want to raise any suspicion, you know. Good point. Well, let's go then. After you, m'lady. You just had to go with the m'lady. That is so cringeworthy! There we are. Finally! I can't wait to get some coffee into my system. Oh, I know how that feels. Like, I need some form of... I need some caffeine! Like, right now, just inject it straight into my fucking wrist. Just, nah. Oh, hello, Metalcore. Nice to see you again. Hey, who's your companion? Can't you just take my order? No! No! Stop! Don't get me started on that shit again. You'll make me cringe. I apologize. Let me try that again. Welcome to our establishment. My name's Adine, and I'll be your waitress today. What can I bring you to? I'll have a coffee. Thank you. And what can I bring the esteemed gentle person on the other side of the table? Oh, Adine, you are not helping here! Stop! Well, I mean, like, I could go for beer right now, to be quite honest. I mean, I've got one right here, so... I think, no problem. I'll be right back. What's her problem? I'm here to order something, not to chit-chat with the employees. Okay, so since I'm gonna have to be a total fuckboy... I think I'm gonna have to agree with her on these things. So, let's say, theoretically, if I was a fuckboy, I'd be like, well, yeah, she can be pretty annoying. I can see that. Here you go. Enjoy. Well, since they are drinking, I guess I should take a sip now as well. Ah, I totally needed that. So, you work in that facility. Oh, you got piss water? Bro. We are not talking about American beer here, okay? This is proper Dutch beer, you know? This is our pride, our joy. This is Heineken! Not just some piss water. This is premium quality, bro. It even says so on the fucking label! I mean, not that that fucking tells me anything, but... And your point is? Well, what's your job there? I mean, what do you do, exactly? We do all kinds of things. The truth is, we just have all kinds of specialized machinery there, which is used by many different people for, well, many different purposes. The building is owned and run by the council, who oversees the schedule. A total fuckboy indeed, since you're way too young for this game? Listen up, cocksucker. I am 19, okay? I am more than old enough for this game. Shut the fuck up. Well, it's quite handy, since you can go from research to testing and even manufacturing, all in the same complex. I started out as a researcher in biology, which is still my main job, but I've been there so long and learned the ins and outs of the building so well that eventually I was asked to take over some managerial duties. Sure, it means more work, but it also allows me to run a personal project every once in a while. Does that sate your curiosity? Not one for beer, it all sucks to me. I mean, hey. Your taste. I mean, you have the right to be wrong. okay. Well, it looks like a fascinating place. many different things, quote unquote. I'm not sure as to call it fascinating, but it sure does give me a lot of opportunities. Oh, I forgot to ask you what you actually plan to do with my blood and the test results. What is this, an interrogation? I call your lawyer if you like. Maybe I should. I'll tell you hit me, then sue for damages. But excuse me, princess. I mean, like I said, if I'm gonna have to be a fuckboy, I would say something like this. She's just like, sorry, I'm just stressed from all the work lately. I'm not getting much respite between my regular work. Overtime, personal projects, and other disturbances like that Remy sticking his nose where it doesn't belong. I should stream Ace Attorney one day. I am actually really wanting to play that. I have played it a little bit before, but I've never really gotten far into it. So I would love streaming that if you guys like. I mean, I would stream it anyway because, hey, my fucking channel, but I mean, I could get onto that. What do you usually do during your free time? Having a good work-life balance is very important, you know? I love my job. I really do. Actually, I love it so much that even in my free time, I still do things that have to do with biology. Yeah, you can really go overboard with that. As I said, I've got the opportunity to do my own project sometimes. So that's what I focus on when I get the chance. It would be a shame to pass up an opportunity like that without using it. With the current influx of work, I rarely leave the facility if I'm not eating or sleeping. Even right now, I'm only on break and have to go back for another shift. Human hits dragon to death with bare hands. Oh, maybe you should do something else for a change. Maybe, but right now that's not really an option. It would help if the council weren't constantly seeking their lackeys to mess with me. So, that wasn't the first time? I mean, I know these kinds of people. They can be really bothersome. Just, you know, keep coming back. No, I suppose I'm on their watch list or something. Why is that? It's a long story, and not one for a first date. So you're saying this is a date? No, I'm saying that even if this was a date, which would be more than whatever this is, it wouldn't be very appropriate. Stories about work aren't very romantic. Well, it's always about work with you. Come on, you're on break. Maybe we should do something that to take your mind off all that for once. Well, like what? I'm not sure. Do you have any other hobbies? Night Sky doesn't know Ace Attorney. How am I even calling you a fucking friend right now? Nah, I'm joking. Don't skip too fast in between. I have to eat dinner. I mean, I'm going at my own pace and I'm voicing all the lines, so I'm already going slower than I would usually play. So, you're gonna have to hurry. I actually discovered that game during an internship at a lawyer's office. Nice. I mean, it is pretty much Lawyer the video game. Not really. Hey, waitress. How can I help you? Do you have anything here to entertain your guests? Any games or other distractions? I'm not sure. Let me go check. I mean, you fucking work here. How do you not know? These are the things you're supposed to know, Dean. Get your shit together. What exactly are you trying to do? Oh yes, press V in game. Okay, pressing V. Self-voicing enabled. Press V to disable. Oh boy.
And just wait and you'll see. I'm being cute and spontaneous.
Oh no.
Just wait. Self-voicing disabled.
No. 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 The anticipation is killing me. Actually, no. It's boredom. It's more for the kids, but we don't really have anything else. That's fine, thank you. Have fun. A board game? Really? I know it's not Knitsky's textile merchant, but I suppose it's better than nothing. Textile merchant? Knitsky? It's a game, never mind. I mean, I don't even know what the fuck that is. Well, I'm not convinced that this will accomplish anything, unless your goal is to make me regret this day. It seems to be a trivia game. Do you have good general knowledge? Do you even know what kind of advanced knowledge I have to memorize and work with every single day? You bet I have good general knowledge. Certainly more than enough to beat a foreigner like you. If you're so confident, maybe we should make a bet. What do you have in mind? Cleverbot plays angels with scaly wings? Yeah, that's basically that. Let's say if I win, I'll get to go on a real date with you. Not fitting me in during your break, no complaining about everything, and no acting as if you're doing me a favor. Especially because it was you who wanted to meet me in the first place. And if I win, I'll have you come in sometime so I can run more tests on you. That's what you want, so be it. Let's do this then. Oh god, I am... Shit! Oh, this is gonna be interesting. Am I gonna win this? Is the question. Well, since it was your idea, it's only fair that I start. So, how does this work? Well, it seems to be simple. We take turns drawing cards and asking questions until we've both asked the number that we agree on beforehand. Whoever gets more right in the end wins. How many questions shall it be then? How about 5? Let's make it 3. Not sure how long this will take, and my break won't be for too long either. Alright, go ahead then. I saw mischief in her eyes, her stare piercing, painted with the hint of an arrogant smirk that exposed her anticipation. She seemed confident that she would win and loved every second of it. Well, we'll just have to show her that we are not that fucking stupid. I mean, I fucking hope so. I mean, it is me we're talking about. So, good luck getting them right. Slowly, her hand went over to the deck of cards and drew the topmost. Round 1. Oh, that stare. Oh, yes. Who is cited as one of our most important historians? His work spanning over 20 books, credited with mapping out our entire history since the beginning of sentience. I think I have heard this one. Remy runs Fist on his computer. Well, that's why it blue screen, so. Now I have to think, did I hear this before? This name seems familiar. I have heard this name before. This one definitely not. At least as far as I know, I would have remembered such a name. I think it's this one. I'm afraid that's wrong. I'm so sorry, Metalcore. Fuck! Well, we're done. Well, how was I supposed to know something like that? It was your challenge. You dig your grave, you lie in it. Besides, it's not as if it wasn't clear to me from the beginning that I'd win, so no surprises there. Shit. Let's see how you fare with your first question. Bring it. How far can you walk into the woods? Only until the middle. Anything after that and you're walking out of the woods again. You did hear his name? You can hear the answer before, but you haven't? Fuck. You're right. That's a rather weird question, though. I suppose I read the right kinds of books growing up. I know most of those trick questions. Let's see what the second question has in store for you, shall we? I hope she's gonna mess up at least once. Looked like 8.1 by the way the BSOD looked. I mean, 8 and 8.1 pretty much sucked, so not terribly surprising. Round 2. That stare is so sharp. Alright, if there are 5 apples and you take away 3, how many do you have? This is a trick question, I think. Or it's a faked out trick question. If there are five apples, so there are five apples somewhere, and you take away three, how many do you have? Well, you have three, because you just took those three apples from somewhere. That is a cleverly worded trick question. I like that. You would assume it's two, because there are five apples. But the thing is, you are the one taking them away, so you would have three apples. That's a clever trick question. Guess you also know your trick questions. Yes! You see, I am very good at I can be very good at reading in between the lines like that. It's all about the way they phrase the question. That's the thing you have to pay attention to. I like those. Apparently so. Okay, here's your question. In which year of our timeline did we gain sentience? Wait, they are talking about timelines here. So do they know that there are multiple timelines? Because that seems like a weird way of phrasing that question. Interesting. Zero. The beginning of our timeline marks the event when we gain sentience. Right again. Have you played this game before? It's a children's game. These questions aren't really a challenge. I'll just go ahead and draw the next card so we can end this. I hope she's gonna mess up on the last one. Okay, number three. Ooh. An adventurer who values his life has to choose between three rooms to cross. Which of the following would be the safest? Okay, that's a good one. Number one. A room filled with poisonous gas. Number two, a room filled with 100 highly trained assassins. Or number three, a room submerged in water filled with alligators that have not eaten in 8 months. Ooh. This is a good one. Well, I mean, it depends on how... This depends on how big the room is. Because if it's not a very big room... Wait a minute. I have to choose between three rooms to cross. Which of the following would be the safest? And he values his life. Shit, I don't know. I think I'm gonna know the answer to this one. An adventurer who values his life has to choose between three rooms to cross. Which one of the following would be the safest? A room filled with poisonous gas, a room filled with 100 highly trained assassins, or a room submerged in water filled with alligators that have not eaten in 8 months? No, wait! The room submerged in water filled with alligators, because I don't think alligators can survive without food for that long. So those alligators would be dead, right? This one you should overthink. So I think it's number three, to be quite honest. He's screwing up, I know him. No, I'm not. Oh, because 8 months is a long time. I don't think they would be alive until then. I think. Because... The question implies he has to choose. But wait. If he has to choose, but he values his life, he wouldn't go through any of these. Because he values his life, then he wouldn't go through any of them. Go for three? Did this motherfucker just spoil me? Think of the other questions. He screws up? Did this motherfucker just spoil me? I mean, he does it? No, I haven't chosen yet. I think I might be over the... We can't say yes or no, can we? No, you cannot. Not a spoiling? Now I'm really not sure which one to take. He thinks for too long? He's screwed up in our hearts already? Shut up! Think back to the previous questions. I mean, the first one was about the guy who has written down most of our history. Meanwhile, the comet is approaching. The second one was a trick question. Fuck! She would be gone by now. You only have a few weeks to... Shut up! Okay, I'm going with three because, like I said, I think they would be dead by then. Nope, in fact... Oh, fuck. No, he should... I knew I should have gone for the none at all. They're all... Fuck! Damn it! Well, the question is poorly worded. Don't blame me, I didn't make this game. Fuck! Well, it looks like this is going to be the last question. Dislike if you answer wrong? Shut up! Fuck you! Let's get it over with already. What is the approximate acceleration speed of a nosediving flyer? I'll have to think about that for a minute. Rip Metalcore eaten by alligators. Shut up! Okay. You guys make me sad. It was worth a try? You fuckers screwed me over. Especially you, Wolf Knight, because you said choose three. Which was giving me hesitations. I was seriously considering... The none at all, because they are pretty much equally deadly. But then you said three. So, I'm blaming you. It's not my fault. Drink away your sorrows, that's it. Fuck off. I was just kidding. I still could have calculated that. Okay, here's the real question. What is the only substance known to be lighter in its solid form compared to its liquid state? Water. That seems to be correct. Of course it is, duh. Fuck. God damn it. Just look at that, I won. It is really badly worded. Yeah, because the question implies that he has to make a choice. AKA you assume that he has no other option. So the question itself is flawed, so I'm blaming both that and Wolf Knight. Well, someone had to. This turned out to be more fun than I expected. Of course, the main reason for that is because I won, but still. I get it, you won, you're great, etc. That is true. So, when should I come in for the tests? Right fucking now, you plebeian. You have to get all three right anyway. Welp. Actually, I'm not sure if I'll get a spot for them in the facility anytime soon, but I'll be sure to let them know, to let you know. I'm quite sure you will. You just sold your body to a sociopathic raptor? I guess I did. It's basically like selling my soul to the devil. But you know what? This wasn't so bad after all. Maybe I'll let you have your date. Oh, she's one of those. Okay. Really? Sure, I mean, you didn't win, but I think you earned it nonetheless. Or maybe I'm just that nice. Okay. Well, it's up to you. Call me if you're interested. I'll let you know. She is a clever girl. I'm still going to collect my prize, though. I'm sure you'll make sure of that. You bet I will. In any case, I should get going now. My break is about to end. Bye! I was not sure what I had expected out of this encounter, but it certainly wasn't this. After all, proposing a proper date was my way of sticking it to her for being rude. Even though I lost the bet, she didn't seem to mind going on a date with me, as long as she got what she wanted. Whether I would follow up on it was up to me, though. I mean, of fucking course I'm gonna follow up on it, because, well, that's me. But she can do all the work, then? More free time. What should I do? Get some well-deserved rest! Because I am not doing any of the fucking other fucking routes yet. Skip ahead. No. You had no chances? Skip! Skip! I dislike every stairs! Check status. I am in good status. Rest because brain hurts? Or wait, Night Sky's a clever girl too? Or wait, a clever boy? Okay, so I'm at least good in her book. Skip. Skip. Okay, so let's... I mean, because I'm doing her route, I'm definitely visiting the production facility. Because, well, it's kind of obvious. I mean, I've already done all of this. Whoop! That's all. Whether or not you get the good ending... Okay, you know what? Since I've never been to Tatsu Park, I'm gonna go there now. Just to see what happens. Because, like I said, I haven't been here before. Tatsu Park, here I am. I don't even know what I'm looking for, though. Let's read the sign. This part is dedicated to Arc. So next time they offer you, skip, I beg you. This park is dedicated to our creator, to whom we owe our sentience and existence. As it is our duty to remember, this place honors them every day with its beauty and grants a place of recreation and contemplation to us all. Okay, look at the map. It's bigger than I thought. I could go north towards Tatsu Avenue, which is apparently is a nice spot to look at the landscape, or south to the political district. Where should I go? Stay in the central area. Search a shrubbery. Yeah, this totally won't look strange or suspicious. Here we go. Hello? I found some dirt. There doesn't seem to be anything else here. You found a handful of dirt. How quaint. Archaeologist. Search the pavilion. You never know what you'll find around a pavilion. Let's do this. Look around here for the stuff. Check everything a few times. There doesn't seem to be anything important here, but at least it provides excellent shade. Remember what Lorem said? I don't know what he said. I was too busy feeling for him. Okay. Oh, again, I guess I should look harder this time. More searching! No, still seems to just be dirt around here, and I don't think I'll need anything more than what I already have. Search it again? I don't know. Search the pavilion again. Nope, nothing here. Search it again. I mean, you guys aren't going to spoil anything for me anyway. I found something! It's a round, smooth orb about the size of a bowling ball. Feeling for him or feeling him? Oh, this is, that's, Ipsum's, little sphere. Not sure what it is, but I'll take it with me, just in case. You acquired a mysterious orb. How mysterious? I know! Oh! Oh, that's clever! Okay, I don't think I'll find anything else here. No, I don't know what to... Okay. Oh. Shut up. Anna, come here, you cunt. And just on time. Now, where is she? I bet he will screw up Anna. He definitely will. I guess I'll have to invite that furry fucker Kevin into my house. God damn it. Hello? What's this? Looks like a message. You didn't search all of the park? He's smart enough to do not, actually? That sentence makes no sense to me, but whatever. Something came up at the last second. Wait for me. It shouldn't be too long. Anna. I guess at the last second is meant in the literal sense here. Or else she could have just called me. Guess we're playing the waiting game then. You need to do some more searching, but it helps with Lorm's other ending. Okay, cool. I'll keep that in mind for the next playthrough. If we do try to get Lorm's good ending. Okay, it's been like an hour and my patience is slowly but surely running out. You know what that reminds me of? Some Red Bull. Or at least, no, this is Bullet energy drink. Drinking two drinks at the same time. Gangsta. I mean, I would wait here. But going home seems like I'm completely cutting off my entire route. Now I am worried that I'm going to take you guys too literal. Which would lead into my fucking up. Go to the archives next. Let's see. Ah! Well, she told me to wait. I've already waited this long, so I guess I can wait a little longer. Watch me fuck up now. I'm not sure who's the world record holder for most patient person is, but now I feel like a contender. Still no sign of her, though. Well, let's try going into her lab. I don't fucking know. Alright, I'm gonna score myself some sweet lab equipment. That's the least she can do for making me wait. Or maybe I'll just wait inside. Standing around here is getting rather tedious. Pushing the door does nothing. Neither does pulling. Guess I'm out of options here. Hey, what's this? At the bottom of the door, the corner of an envelope was noticeably sticking out. I did it right? I mean, I thought I told you guys not to say anything about that, but still. Well, I mean, I've waited for this one. If you stop along the way, so don't stop. Well, I mean, I've been waiting here for this long, and I don't think I'm gonna get to do anything else, so I'm gonna take it! Pulling at the corner, I was now holding the envelope in my hands. Well, I gotta pass the time somehow, right? I mean, there is literally no one here. It is evening, there's no one else coming! Let's see, dear Anna, appointments for the next month, treatment plan, Dr. Valado. I probably shouldn't be looking at this. Quickly, I put the letter back in the envelope and pushed it through the gap in the door. You looked at Anna's envelope. Naughty. I'm a snoop. What are you looking at? Your beautiful door. Where have you been all this time? Reading comprehension must not be your strong suit, because my note clearly said I'd be back soon. Well, yes, but it depends on what your definition of soon is. And this is not soon! I've been waiting here for literal hours, you cunt! Note to self, the word soon now refers to a time span of over 2 hours when waiting for a scheduled appointment. Has it really been that long? It certainly didn't feel like it. Yeah, well, that is if you have something to fucking do. I have been sitting here for hours. Well, you just broke the mailing secret. You'll be picking up soap in the dragon prison. Listen, mate, I don't use soap. Joke's on you, motherfucker. Alright, sorry for making you wait. Oh, you better be. I just told you that I am, so get off my back. Do you want this date now or not? I suppose so. Oh, Metacross asks, has already been trained for that by Bryce? I feel like I'm doing something wrong here, but you guys said be a fuckboy. This is my definition of a fuckboy, just being a complete asshole. I guess we missed our movie. Can we see the late screening or something? That was the late screening. The theater's closed now. Oh, maybe we should reschedule. That won't work. At least, not for me. Today was the only day I could leave early. I won't have another chance anytime soon. So, what do we do now? Uh-oh, night sky is umming. Maybe the coffee place is still open? I don't know. Soap? What is soap? Guess that's better than nothing. Clothes as well! That's just peachy. Why do you keep working so late anyway? Because what I'm doing is important. You're doing cancer research, right? And who told you that? Damien, I stopped by your lab some time ago, but you weren't there. That shark-born bastard! What else did he tell me? Did he tell you about me? Well, nothing much. The whole thing wasn't really about you anyway. I see. Sounds like you two don't get along that well. That's the understatement of the century. Being trapped in a small room with the likes of him for hours on end every day is a scenario born of a sick mind with the intention of making me suffer as much as possible. Certainly doesn't make my research any easier. Oh, the stress doesn't help you either, and it's not worth jeopardizing your health over. Don't overwork yourself. You can't save anyone if you're dead. Well, if I don't find a cure, no one else will. No one else can. Besides, I was only late today because I got your stupid blood work ready. You have the test results? Yeah. Want to know what I have to say about them? Well, definitely. I was the most curious test. Okay, how much do you know about genetics? A little bit, I guess. I mean, I am a fucking biologist. That's kind of, you know, part of my fucking job. Don't worry. I'll put it into words that are easy for you to understand. To start off, I found that, on average, about 90% of your genes are homologous to our species genes. That may seem like a lot, but put into perspective, about 50% of your DNA is also shared with fruit. Yeah. To further elaborate, you and your human neighbor back home are probably around 99.9% genetically similar. If you compare the various sentient species we have here to each other, they would only be around 95 to 97% similar. As for what exactly all of this tells us, although a match of 90% sounds like a lot, it's not as much as you might think. Still, for two beings from a different world altogether, that is quite remarkable. Yeah, lady, you don't even know half of it. It's, complicated. Joke's on you, Anna. You were made up in someone's sick mind. Well, beyond DNA, the biggest similarity between us is within the brain structure. But that's not surprising, considering our high-level cognitive abilities. That'll surprise Maverick. What do you mean? He doesn't seem to like very humans very much. I'm sure he'll be displeased to know how similar we are. Oh, he doesn't like anyone, really. He's just like me in that way. Yeah, you two would make a great couple. You're a little late for that. I'm already his ex-girlfriend. I mean, this isn't very surprising, if I can be quite honest. Really? How did that go? Not how you might think. It actually went pretty well. For a while, at least. But in the end, we both got too absorbed in our jobs until we realized we had drifted apart too much and agreed it would be better if we just broke up. That is very mature, if I can be quite honest. I still respect him for the work he does. I mean, we even used to solve crime together. I'd be in the lab running tests and he'd be out in the field chasing after the perps. Those were good times. I guess nowadays he just chases after me. Maverick has already hit that. I am not sure how to feel about that. What? I don't know, maybe I shouldn't say that, but if you know him, maybe you can help me out. Well, I certainly can't help you if you don't tell me what's going on. Okay, but this is just between us, alright? Sure, whatever. Maverick is convinced that I'm the accomplice of a crime. He made a point to tell me that he's searching for proof to legally arrest me, or worse. Sighs? Oh, I wouldn't worry about that. Really? It's nothing. He can't find any proof that doesn't exist. That's a typo. Well, still, it doesn't feel nice to be threatened and stalked, especially by someone like him. Oh man, I just played Anna's Rude last night. Oh boy. Sad shit. That's just him. He gets way too into it once he sets his sight on something. I noticed. Well, it's his job. What do you expect? I wish he'd just leave me alone. It wasn't always like this, you know? Oh boy, we're gonna get some backstory on Maverick. A couple of years ago, he was assigned to this one case. Flashback! He was still relatively new on the force, young and eager to help. Then reality came crashing down on him. There was a serial killer who shook up the whole town. The victims were apparently eaten. We later found out that the killer's actions were because of a degenerative disease, which brought his feral nature to the foreground. At that point, he was just a wild animal, turned into a cannibal that hunted under the shadow of night. Wow, that's rough. Everyone in town was up in arms, terrified that they'd be next. The police did everything they could. A curfew was instated and patrols guarded the streets at night. And then they found him munching on his fifth victim. Poor little Maverick was not prepared for what he would find. Prepare the tissues? Stand back, Maverick. I'll handle this. Miles? It was his brother? Whoa. Whoa, that... Okay. Step away from the body, Miles. Miles couldn't comprehend their words and only saw rivals who wanted to take away his prey. Dude, that's rough. Fuck. and he wasn't about to just let go of it without a fight. I see that Bryce doesn't have his scars on the neck here, so I assume that's where he got bitten. Miles raised his head from his kill, blood dripping from his maw. The officer's breaths were smothered by the deathly stillness of the night. Fangs bared, the feral dragon snarled and stood strong in front of his meal, preparing to protect it from the two who intruded upon his territory. Whatever this is, Miles, it's over. Don't make it worse now. Yeah, there it is. In an instant, Miles was upon Bryce. They clashed in a flurry of teeth and claws. Miles had the advantage with a small frame and quick movements, and Bryce could not get a clear hit in. It all happened so fast that Maverick didn't know what to do. Dude, he's gonna kill his own brother. They rolled on the ground and Bryce ended up on his back, as helpless as a turtle. Miles pinned him and clamped his jaws on his neck. Bryce's claws were the only thing preventing Miles from biting down, and they were slipping, slick with blood and quivering with fatigue as he tried to push him off. For a brief moment, Bryce thought he'd met his end, when the jaws suddenly relaxed and he was able to dislodge them. When he looked up, he saw that Maverick had managed to get Miles from behind. He bit through his brother's neck from above. Blood flowed down from Maverick's jaws and over Miles' lifeless body. Bryce had been saved, but the young dragon wore a wide-eyed, empty stare. Maverick blamed himself on not taking better care of his brother. He knew Miles had problems and was taking medication for it, but he wished he could have done more to help him. The medication wasn't the right one, by the way. Maverick takes solace in the fact that he was able to save Bryce, but he's never been the same since that incident. Now he scrutinizes everyone and everything. Wow, that just took a really fucking dark turn. Jesus. That is not what I had expected. I'm not sure how that's supposed to help me. I mean, listen here, you little shit. This basically explains why the guy is the way he is. And it makes perfect sense. I mean, doesn't improve our situation right now, but at least you'll have an understanding of why he does. So don't be such a little cunt back, bro. Well, it doesn't, but now you know why he is how he is. It's not unusual for him to act like this, so you might just have to wait it out. Love me now, lol. Anyway, let's get back to your test results, since you were so interested. Did you want a copy of them? Yeah, I'd appreciate that. No problem. I heard you also wanted Raze's blood. Well, of course, I invited him over too, but that was before you arrived here. And I thought what we had was special. Oh, it is. Raze was too stuck up to agree to anything. Main protagonist can be an asshole? Not on Discord, y'all hate me? Nah, not really, bro. He wouldn't even participate in an exhilarating round of trivia board games? Not even that, can you believe it? I can almost see the sarcasm dripping from your mouth. Still, it's kind of a shame. Would have been interesting to compare your blood to his. What a shame indeed. Oh, let's just enjoy our romantic date in the back alley of a coffee shop. Of course. Unless you want to take this someplace else. What, you don't like hanging around dirty back alleys? Hey, I bet you've never had a date in an alley before. I haven't. Not sure I ever wanted to. Where's your sense of adventure? Oh, hang on. There it is. Yes, I can feel the adventure kicking in. I'm getting kind of hungry. I figured we'd be having a meal over on our date. What? Can't you go a few hours without having to stuff your face? I could offer you a handful of dirt, if that's to your taste, Metalcore. Well, I already have my own dirt. Oh, really? What kind of dirt would that be? only the finest governmentally funded dirt from Tatsu Park. Your filthy back alley stuff has nothing on this. You win this round. Either way, a side dish would be nice. I know this one place that never closes. Let's go there. Is it called, your fucking house? Sure. After several minutes of walking, Anna led me to the outskirts of town. We arrived at a farmhouse. On one side, fields stretched toward the horizon. And on the other side were lush green hills with fenced populations of animals. What kind of restaurant is this supposed to be? Self-serve? Are you kidding me? Ah, you're a bad girl. I know. How well can you hunt? Me, even if I knew how, it's not like I have any equipment here. Equipment? What a sissy. I mean, that's how we compensate for our, you know, the fact that we are, you know, basically weak monkeys. I mean, you know, if I had a hunting rifle, I could get you everything you want. You wouldn't even have to have, you wouldn't even have to do anything for it. Oh, you've got hands and teeth. What more do you need? A long range weapon, maybe? Like fire? I suppose even you could make use of that. Alright, since I'm apparently the only one capable of acquiring food, I'll be right back. Ooh! Anna walked over to a fenced enclosure of animals that reminded me of sheep. She crouched and squeezed herself through the bars, after which I lost sight of her. Waiting game 2.0, start! It took only a couple of minutes for her to return, dragging one of the animals behind her with now bloody jaws and hands. Dinner's ready. What kind of animal is this? It's called a mouflon. The fuck kind of an animal is that? Anyway, do you have a part you'd prefer? See how nice I am? I'm even letting you choose first. I need to know something real quick because I don't know what this is. The entrails and internal organs? Let's go for the offal, fuck it. What's the worst that could happen? Good choice. Using one of her claws, she skinned the dead mouflon and divided it into various pieces. Just listen to the crunching sound, it's... That actually kind of turns me on. Holy crap. Rump gotta get a piece of that ass. I mean, if we're gonna go back to our roots here, I mean, I might as well go all the way. You want yours grilled or raw? I mean, we are terrible at digesting raw food, so... Well, grilled. Unless prepared properly, raw meat carries a significant risk of diseases for us. How inept can your species even be? You can't hunt on your own and you need tools and help at every step. You don't even have claws to cut things up. I mean, we have some, we used to have some pretty amazing things back at home. I mean, I could take out a sheep from a couple of kilometers away. I highly doubt you can do that. I'm not sure how you could ever survive in the wild. Seriously, what god did you piss off to end up like that? I mean, the gods that we have are usually kind of assholes, so... None. We were made in God's image. Evolution? Well, I guess after millions of years of evolution, nature decided that we didn't need those abilities anymore. Instead, we got very articulate hands and arms and our upright stance. Those let us do many other things. Like what? Who builds everything in your society? Who's responsible for the delicate tasks like assembling electronics, manufacturing, or cooking and bartending? That's mostly us, the runners. We got proper hands after all. Oh, I bet you do. Now compare your arms to mine. Ours are much longer and have way more mobility. Especially our fingers. They have an incredible amount of articulation. The difference between you and me is about as big as the difference between you and another of your species. Just imagine what we could do with our advantages. Oh, you think you can school me? Sure I can. Don't get cocky. We've overcome the limitations of individual species with all of our technology. Actually, we have technology back home that is far superior to yours. At least, it used to be. I'd love to see it, though we've already gathered plenty of information on your tech from the databases contained on the PDA. What will you do when we catch up? Well, if you get there, we'll see. She opened her maw wide before a liquid shot from both corners of her mouth and onto the... Before a liquid shot from both corners of her mouth and onto the ground below the parts of the mouflon she had prepared. Romance with the taste of blood? I mean, I can dig it. You know, it's nice. Kinky. After a few seconds, the liquid burst into flame, heating up our dinner. That's a neat trick. I bet you wish you could do that, huh? Oh, I would totally be burning everything down. It's probably not a good idea to, you know, give me that responsibility. I'm not sure. Why not? It would be a neat ability to have, but I don't think I'd want a deadly weapon at my disposal at all time. Furthermore, I'm not sure what could happen if other humans had access to that skill. Good point. How does that work anyway? Don't you ever burn your mouth? Not at all. There are actually two different components. They only catch on fire when a sufficient quantity of both is present. Interesting. That's gonna be a new gallery image. Nice. Like I said, I can dig it. The flames weakened and grew smaller until they went out, revealing steamy, appetizing pieces of meat. Help yourself. I grabbed the piece but dropped it as soon as I felt the heat on my fingertips. Ouch, that's still hot. Can't take a little heat, huh? That's too bad. Unaffected by its temperature, she took a piece in her hand, tore a chunk out of it with her teeth, and started chewing. Spitting lava is pretty cool indeed. I mean, the way she describes it, it's not really a, it wouldn't be like lava. It's basically sort of a, you know, self-igniting, well, it would basically, I think it would basically be something like gasoline. Romantically. I guess your scales are a good insulator. Evidently so. How does it taste? Just wonderful. Stolen goods always taste best. I can already picture the old farmer reduced to tears after he discovers one of his precious mouflons is gone. Oh, you're a wild one. Thanks. I could teach you a thing or two. I think it should be cool enough for your sensitive little fingers now. Carefully, I grabbed one of the pieces, which by now had indeed cooled down enough not to burn me anymore, and took a bite. It was a little bland, I had to admit, but not bad for something that was alive less than an hour ago and prepared in the wild. I did like your mouflon a la Anna. Oh, she speaks French as well. Not bad. Especially at that price. Well, how often do you just go out and hunt on your own? Only when necessary, or when I feel like it. I still go to fancy restaurants because I can afford it, but they don't mean too much to me. I mean, I don't like fancy restaurants, you know, too high class. You know, usually filled with prudes and people who take themselves way too fucking seriously. No fun. Looks like he's Well, for me, it's all about the experience, and one isn't necessarily better than the other. I can see your point. Unusual, but fun. I can see your point. This certainly isn't how I thought the evening would go, but it was pretty fun. Anyways, I'm stuffed. Me too. There's still plenty left over. What are we gonna do with it? We can just leave it here. Hey, maybe the old farmer will help himself to it. Bad French? Shut up. Mouflon Alana. How nice of us to leave some for him. Yeah, he should pay me for cooking such a nice meal. We should probably leave before that senile has-been wakes up from his evening nap. Omelette du fromage? Yeah, let's go. Well, that was interesting. Omelette au fromage? Oh yeah, I know that was actually wrong. Wait a minute, I've got something for you. Here you go, your test results, black on white. Thanks, but did you really need to spend all that extra time getting this done today? I just wanted to get it over with when I had the chance. Well, maybe you should start thinking about not working so late on a regular basis. It might do you some good, Anna. Why do you think so? I'm just saying, if it usually gets as bad as it did today, that's not a good sign. I just didn't pay attention to the time, but I guess that's because I barely go out anyway, and I didn't even think about watching the clock. Okay, point taken. So, what are you gonna do? I'll think about it. You know, now that this date is officially over, if I don't work overtime every single day, I could fit you in for your end of the deal. Of course you didn't forget about that. I'll let you know the details, or just call me if I forget. Sure. Sweet! Status. We're still on good with her. Okay, so we got a bunch of stuff, which is nice. So we're gonna read, we're gonna blap! Wait a minute! You know Anna, right? I've met her, yes. How about her assistant? I met him once or twice. Well, that's him. Oh, now it's the fucker that gets killed. Okay, I was about to say, does she die anyway? No! Are you okay? Well, I'm fine. Let's get this over with. And here's more bad news. Okay, this is... No. Not the worst possibility. It's quite shocking. Hang on, I've done this already. Why is it not letting me skip? We're being involved, so his involvement is not undeniable. That was weird that it didn't let me skip there. If you don't do the second date with Anna, she dies? Okay. Yeah, I'm fine. Fuck that guy. Tiny bit. Oh, well, he was a dick anyway. With his colleague, Anna. Police archives, remember? Yeah. Okay, so Anna's the one who found his body. A few things have changed, some additional information. She can be found in the production facility. So you're interested in the underground building found near the portal. I realize you might actually be able to help us with that. Since it's suspected to be of human origin, your opinion would be greatly appreciated. I guess I should add archaeologist to my resume. Okay, and another witness. The store clerk. Okay, so I can do two things. I'm going to do the production facility and the archives. Yeah, by the way, I think I know what to do there. I'm going to have to snoop around in the trash. Here we have Lorem. Lorem, right? Did you get a chance to think about what I told you last time? Don't worry, I didn't lose your number. They keep me pretty busy, so I don't really have much free time. Well, if anything changes, give me a call. I will. I gotta go now, so take care. You too. This should be the right place. Oh, it's you. I'm a little busy, so I'm not sure if I should take any visitors at the moment. Well, I have a few questions about the murder of your colleague. Is that so? Why do you get to go around asking questions like that? Is it a matter of human interest? Actually, yes, you could say so. Interesting. What's in it for me? Hey, I already agreed to your tests. I'm not sure what else I could offer you. Besides, I'm working with the police, so your cooperation would be greatly appreciated. Oh, you're working for our police? Now you really have my attention. I want to see where you're going with this. So by all means, go ahead. Okay, so what happened when you saw him last time you saw him alive? Lorem au fromage? I saw him yesterday evening. There were some tests I needed to run overnight, so instead of staying late to set them up, I had Damien do it. That's what colleagues are for, right? Well, what happened when you found him? I might have left early yesterday, but I made up for it by coming in early today, before anything else. That's why I was the one to find him. I was on my way to my office when I saw him lying in the middle of the hallway, in a puddle of his own blood. What was your relationship to him? We were colleagues, nothing more. I heard that you didn't particularly like him. Yeah, but that's not unusual. I don't like most people. Aw, so that means I'm special. He really didn't like me, though. Why's that? He was jealous of my success, and it showed. I seem rather calm for someone whose colleague was just murdered. People die every day. It's a simple fact of life. Besides, I don't see you crying about him either. I didn't know him that well, so it's not like someone I actually cared about died. The world stops spinning for no one. Life goes on, and for me, that means being without an assistant for a while. Nope, that's all. That'll be all. Thank you, Anna. My pleasure. Time to head back. You interrogated Anna. Well done, Metalcore. Interrogator 2. Sweet! Okay, don't go to the portal. Aw, she likes you, Metalcore. Status, we're still good. I'm gonna stay inside. Okay, so we're gonna visit the police archives because I had something to find there. Police archives. Da 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 da. I'm kinda busy right now. Okay, I'm gonna rummage through the trash because that's one of the things I haven't done there yet. Right, here goes nothing. Hello? Huh? What's this? Base finder. Where you need to pay twice the GDP of the Netherlands per month to get internet past 5k? I mean, I don't pay a whole fucking lot for my internet and I get like 150 down, 20 to 30 up. It's a flat base with a circular indent at the top. Looks like it could be useful. If nothing else, it might make a nice souvenir. You acquired a mysterious base. How basic. LOL! Play a prank. Ooh. Structural damage report. Oh, the witness report from Anna is good. Nothing new to us, but it's nice to have her statement in writing. Not bad, Metalcore. Not bad at all. Thanks for your help. Do what I can. I like the music when you have to decide to stay or go to the portal. Yeah, it's nice. Hey, yo, Anna. I saw a girl. I thought she liked me. She just played with us for fun, I suppose. I'm sure. I really hope the soundtrack to this game gets released. It already has been. If you get the digital deluxe edition, you get the soundtrack. So you already can get it. Just buy the digital deluxe edition or the upgrade to it. There you are. I was wondering if you'd even show up. OST is really good? Yeah, it is good. Sexy time? Well, I'm an honorable person. Good for you, and for me, as it turns out. Fuck. Follow me, please. Oh, boy. Here we go. Now strip for me, boy. So, what exactly is this room? It's our testing room for research on life subjects. And what exactly do you test here? You'll see that soon enough. I intend to use this facility to its fullest potential. Oh, she is gonna be probing my asshole! I mean, Bryce already resized it, so I mean... You know, if I fart now, you just hear a low... Boom. You know, if I don't clench hard enough, if I walk outside and there's a slight breeze, you can hear it whistling in the wind. I see. Let's start with this one. What's that? I can get a good look at your bone structure, muscle groups, and organs with this. For the finer details, we'll need a different machine. Would you please lie down here? Of course. Before we start, can I ask about your qualifications? You can trust me, I'm a doctor. I don't like it when people tell me to trust them, okay? I'm a very distrusting bastard. What kind of doctor? Well, Doctor of Pharmacy is the only one I currently hold, but I know how to operate this machinery. That doesn't exactly inspire confidence. You think I'd let an opportunity like this go to waste by not doing research? I'll have you know that I'm very qualified to perform these tests. If you say so. Needs more alcohol. Now, please try not to move too much while this is running. And how long will that be? Good question. I suppose we'll see soon enough. Oh, fuck! I mean, soon enough is a time span over 2 hours now, so rip. And what do we do now? Just wait until it's over? Well, what do you want me to do? Dance for you so you don't get bored? I wouldn't mind that. I'm sure you wouldn't, but I'm afraid I don't provide those kinds of services. You know, when I heard that something happened at the facility, I thought it might have been you. It's quite something, isn't it? You know, if I stayed as late as I used to, it might have been me instead of Damien. And it's only because you told me not to stay late so often that I wasn't there that night. Still, somebody died. I'm not crying over that bastard! Alright, you can move again. Does that mean I'm done? That's a good one. We're just getting started. What about the results? Don't hold your breath. It'll be processing for some time, and the resulting data will be so vast that I'll probably end up studying it for days. Let's collect some samples now. Where should I start? Well, wherever you like. Show me your claws. That would be fingernails in my case. I suppose you're right. It would be insulting to call those tiny little finger things of yours claws. They'd probably break off before you could make use of them in any practical ways. Well, just one more way nature gave us the short end of the stick. So, which part would be fine for me to cut off? Well, take a piece from the white part. The rest you see is attached to the finger. Hold still, then. Don't cut off too much. No worry, I only need enough to put it under a microscope. There, was that so bad? Do you want me to put a bandage on your little boo-boo? Whatever. Oh, I guess with the right training I can make something out of you after all. And what now? Now it'll go right under the microscope. She got up and sat down at the table. Intently, Anna stared at a device while messing around with the nail clipping. Let's see... Putting your fingernail on a microscope is something we used to do in middle school. Quiet, please. There's a scientist that work here. Okay. Whatever. This structure looks a lot like keratin. Well, if I remember correctly, that is actually the case. And because I'm a curious bastard. What are fingernails made of? Fucking hell. What are fingerling potatoes? No. Fingernails made of. Keratin. Haha. You know, I paid at least some attention in biology. I at least paid attention in biology. Oh my god, she's so attractive. We're a dragon. That's because it is. Well, that's not much of a surprise, really. Keratin is the substance that forms the claws on us dragons and most of the animals here. At least as far as mammals, reptiles, and birds are concerned. So, why you would retain the structure but not do anything useful with it is beyond me. Let's get better. They grow continuously, so they need to be cut regularly. What happens if you don't cut them? I mean, they will start growing in circles until they'll eventually break off, probably. Well, they just keep growing. How much can they keep growing? I think they can grow to pretty much whatever length you can get them. Well, pretty much indefinitely, you know, until we, you know, bite the dust. Do they get thicker at least, or what else happens when they grow? They just get longer. What a hassle. So, how long are you planning on keeping me here? Getting impatient already? I'm just saying, our day didn't take all that long, and you mentioned you'll already have days worth of data from that machine. Well, we never specified any terms, and I sat out our date until it was officially over. This will certainly go by much quicker if you can show a little patience. Well, I'll just shut up then. Thank you. By the way, how do you feel about needles? Well, go ahead and poke me if you need to. I see. I'll make the most of it then. I don't mind it all that much. No, it's like, you know, it'll sting for a second, but that's it. But I mean, I'm the kind of bastard who's, you know, when he gets his blood taken, I'm just like, ha! That actually flows at a pretty fast rate. Holy crap! I just have that sort of morbid curiosity, just like, huh, that's interesting. Oh, you'll need to remove some layers for the next part. Oh, here we go with the stripping. What are you going to do? These are just some electrodes, and I'll also measure your brain activity with one of those helmets. Alright. There you go. What is it now? It's kind of cold in here. Implying that Amira's attractive? She looks like a fucking triceratops. Is it? I suppose it might be for you, considering your lack of fur. Implying she counts as a dragon? Necronomicon says she is? No. Luckily, our skills are pretty good insulators, as you saw last time. It actually goes both ways. We're pretty resistant to both heat and cold. Just let me know if I turn blue. You turn blue when you get cold? I'd like to see that. It was just a joke. Besides, when that happens, it's usually too late to get out of it again unscathed. What a shame. This will also take a while. I want to have a good reference and see how your rates change. Your head shape is a little different from ours, but I think this one should do the trick. Perfect, just as if it was made for you. I mean, maybe it is. You don't fucking know. I'm not so sure of that. By the way, how can you even be sure that your machinery will not have adverse effects on me? I suppose I can't. That is mildly unsettling. Well, your physiology is similar enough to ours that there shouldn't be any problems. I see. Now, I'm going to ask you a few questions. What is this, a polygraph test? No, this is something completely different. I'm also measuring your brain activity here. Besides, I don't really care about the truthfulness of your answer. Rather, this is to establish your natural highs and lows of the values I'm measuring. Well, go ahead then. Let's start with the easy ones. Just say no to the following three questions. It doesn't matter if it's true or not. Understood? Does this question... No. Am I going to be a smartass? I set myself up for this one, didn't I? Yes, you did. The question starts now. Are you human? No. I see. Is your favorite color maroon? No. Interesting. Have you been convicted of any crime? No. I see. Now we'll get to the real part. You can answer the following questions however you like. Got it. Did it make you uneasy when you had to answer all the questions negatively? Not really. I mean, you told me to, so I just did. I see. Interesting. Have you taken a liking to anyone here since you arrived? Well, yes. I see. Did you have any ulterior motives when you came to our world, or is it as simple as we are led to believe? I mean, saving you, I guess, is an ulterior motive? No comment. I see. That's all for this test. You can take off the helmet and I'll take care of the electrodes. This kind of seemed like an interrogation. I wanted to keep it simple by asking questions that could get a reaction. I see. It's kind of a shame because in the end, the lack of additional subjects for this test means those results might not be very useful to us. We'd probably need a few more humans. Then why do them in the first place? All the data's still useful, just not as useful as it could be. And besides, I did tell you I'd make the most of this room. Motives? I wanted to bang dragons? Well, what's next? I'm not sure yet. Do I want to get close enough to examine mucosa and orifices? Motive? I wanted to touch your butt? What is mucosa? Mucosa. Okay, so membranes. Implying that Remy is not in a BDSM relationship with Emira? Well, there's only one person in this room who can answer that question. I guess so. We quarantined Reza when he initially arrived here, but skipped the procedure with you. After examining Reza, we didn't think humans by themselves posed any danger. Nevertheless, who knows what kind of illnesses and bacteria you might be housing as an alternate host. I'm not taking that risk without a full protective suit. Does that mean your procedures are going to get a lot more invasive? No, I'm just not in the mood to put the suit on and sterilize the whole room. To be fair, I haven't heard of anyone I've been in contact with getting any strange diseases thus so far. Sure, but then I'd have to ask you if any of those actually got close enough to you. As in, intimately close. No orifice examinations then. For the next part, we'll actually have to go outside. That sounds like fun. Depends. Here, strap this to your arm. What's this? Probably testing my blood pressure. A handheld monitor. I want to measure how you perform during exercise. Yes, ma'am. That's a good little human. Oh, she likes that. She is definitely the man in the relationship. Let's go then, shall we? Sure thing. And now? Ask Bryce. Take one lap around the block. I'll be waiting for you here. You can go as fast or slow as you want, but try not to stop until you're back here. I'll be monitoring you, so I'll know if you try to do anything fishy. I wouldn't do such a, well, piece of cake. Easier said than done, Metalcore. I'll be watching. Anyway, you can start whenever. The monitor should take care of the rest. Trying for consistent speed, I started with a light jog. Soon, I was outside the gate and around the corner when I met an unexpected surprise. Hey, Metalcore. Hey, Remy. Long time no see. Indeed. Just enjoying the fresh air, I see? Yeah. You know, if you ever want to come by and visit the library or need to know anything, feel free to ask me. I will, thanks. My pleasure. Afterwards, I finished my lap around the block, arriving only a few minutes after I had started. I suppose it was too much to ask for a lap without any breaks? Maybe I shouldn't have expected you to be as fit as we are. I got distracted on the way. How so? Did you have to stop and smell some flowers? I met Remy. Remy? Oh, I wouldn't mind if that bastard kicked the bucket too. Jesus, everyone here has it in for Remy. Holy crap. Well, what do you have against him? He's such a self-righteous do-gooder who can't help but stick his nose where it doesn't belong. Yeah, I can see that as being really annoying. I don't care what he does as long as he doesn't mess with me, but he does mess with me, so I do care. Anyways, I've got your data, so we can head back inside if you're not too exhausted to walk. Of course. Looking at your data, it's kind of hard to evaluate without having any reference points. How much exercise do you usually get? Well, a little. I see. You sure get to ask me a lot of questions here. All just part of the tests. Though I think those were all the tests I needed to run on you for today. Does that mean we're done here? Oh, some of the data from the scanning machine has been processed. We can look at some pretty pictures of you. Unflattering as they may be. Well, you don't have to look if you don't want to. Oh, right. I totally forgot that you are a mammal. To encounter an intelligent mammal of all things. Well, reasonably intelligent at the very least. Why is that so surprising? You already have your myths about humans. Well, myths are myths. Having you here in the flesh is an entirely different thing. It's not like I could use our myths to get a scan like this one. It just seems so funny to me. Do you nurse your young from your teats as well? Well, we do. Let me just study your muscle groups for a bit. You want me to take my clothes off again? I meant the pictures. Oh, I see. That fills me with confidence! You can stay for a bit longer in case I have any questions. Okay. While I continued sitting on the bed, she went up to her table and started looking at the scans of muscle groups. As we talked, her eyes never left the screen. Well, some of these structures are very similar to those found in Damien's kind. I'm not surprised. His stature is similar enough. True, true. Now shut up and let me concentrate. Does that approach ever work? What are you talking about? You being that rude to everyone? Ooh, I think we have just hit a nerve there. We're done here. Get out. But you can't take what you dish out, huh? Oh, I mean, we're still good. Suddenly she got up, a look of rage crossed her face. I said, get the heck out of here! She grabbed my arm and roughly walked me to the door. After shoving me outside, she quickly closed the door behind me. Okay. I mean, Guy has a point. On the other hand, I mean, I think she will be smart enough to realize that she's being kind of a hypocrite. And I hope. Fail, rip. God damn it. Redo? Are we gonna have to redo this now? Are you serious? Rip, rip. Definitely redo. God damn it! Oh wait, he didn't save. Yes, I didn't. So we are literally gonna have to redo everything. So we are redoing the entire fucking thing. God damn it! Okay, but I have some other options that I actually wanted to do anyway. God damn it! Hang on, I keep the achievements, right? I mean... Okay, we're gonna meet with Anna. You messed up. Also, Lorem died. Wait. Yeah, well, now you're too late! Autosave? Well, you're too late. I'm restarting now. Neutral ending? Well, you're too late. You're too late. check for autosaves. I mean, I'm pretty sure it doesn't have... Treat her like a queen. I mean, I could check the autosave, but then I would have to start again. It's not too late if you want to give it a try. No, I'm pretty sure it's too late. I already restarted. Okay, so I'm just gonna try over again, okay? Good to know we see eye to eye on this. Oh, and thanks for the blood, by the way. The results aren't in yet, but I'll let you know when they are. Skip. I wish I could do that. What did I do? Apparently, I messed up, okay? Well, Ripperoni. Well, I guess, and I'm downing the rest of this now. I mean, not the entire thing, but just a little bit. And you can't spend time with her again? Oh, so that's basically cut off. Did you keep the spear in the base? I can't tell. What a lucky coincidence. It is, isn't it? So, where are we going? Check items. Yeah, I kept everything. Okay, cool. So, where are we going? I don't know where you're going, but I think I need a coffee or five. You can tag along if you like. Plus one. Ugh! It'll be my pleasure. We'll see if it'll be mine as well. I hope you brought your own money though, because I'm not sharing. I didn't, but everything I purchased is taken care of. Okay. I'll take a coffee as well. That does. Good to know. Say before Anna chapter 3, it's a long dialogue scene. I didn't get why the protagonist... Now we named the stream Screwing Up Hard. Yeah, that's okay. Okay, the blunt test results. Okay, call your lawyer. Okay, I guess you don't like questions then. Sorry, I'm just stressed out from all the work. All right. Okay, so now we get to do this again. Is it hurting when you see a play without ever saving? Now it will be even worse. Shut up! I never planned on safe scumming anyway, but, you know, I messed up. So I know it's not this guy, so it has to be Hezekiel. How could you even know something like that? You have only been here for what, a few days? Looks like the bitch got me instead? Yeah! That was a lucky guess. You won't be so lucky again! Let's see how you fare with your first question. Bring it. Bites you in the ass every time. Okay, how far can you walk in the woods? Okay, round two. That was the apples question, right? I forget. Take away three. How many do you have? Well, you have three. No more trick questions. Zero. Time traveler perks, winning trivia competitions. That's between which room would be the safest? Well, none. That's right. All the rooms are equally deadly. Alligators can go up 2 years without more food. 2 years or more without food, making room number 3 as deadly as the others. The other two rooms should not require any explanation. At least according to this card. To be honest, I think the answer is debatable. Don't worry, I'll still count it as a right answer for you. No need to get your tail caught in the door about it. Looks like this is going to be the last question. Just get it over with already. Oh, a nosedive flyer. Each ending feels kind of sad no matter if it's good or bad. Yeah. We're kidding. Water seems to be correct. I am general knowledge. Sweet! Well, it appears to me that our game has ended in a tie. What do you propose? I say we both get our rewards. After all, we each made a good effort to get them. Fine with me. I won't have us spawn the facility to test for a while, so I suppose the next time we meet, it'll be a date. Really, what I expect from you on this date, you better be on your best behavior. I'll try. Thank you. In any case, I should head back to work. Break's over. See you soon. Of course, and I'll make sure you deliver your part of the deal. See you soon. Also, have you seen Vara yet? I think I have. Well, despite all odds, I managed to match a perfect score in the game we played. Yes! No, he hates secondaries? Well, I have probably seen him or her already. I think that's a her. That's the little pink dragon, right? Even though my bet of forcing her to go on a proper date with me was more to get back at her for her earlier rudeness. I had not expected this outcome. I was not even sure what I expected from this meeting in the first place, but now I was locked into going on a date with her and being her own personal guinea pig. Whether anything good would come of this, I wasn't sure either. So he never called Sebastian yet? No, I haven't. I focus on one route at a time. Okay, so you guys were saying about play with Sebastian already? No! Production facility. Because you think secondaries are entire routes? No, I just want to focus on one story at a time! Shut up! Let's go to Tatsu Park then, I guess. Because there was something here. One night stands? Okay, let's look at the map. Open this hatch. Oh, hello! It's pointing up. I know this! Should I go in here, though? Is that a good idea, or is that gonna take a long time? Should I or should I not? That would flag Anna's death? No, it doesn't. See, there are some messages on my phone. What do people want? Chat, hurry up! Attention in the other place with Blathers when he looked at the map? I mean, I don't fucking know. Going in isn't a bad idea. You're just buying another item by the time you wait. You could have done it already. Okay. I have a picture of the thing. I think it was like button one, button two, then something, something. Press the first button. Press the second button. Turn counterclockwise. And it opens! Ha ha! I looked down to see the maintenance tunnels for the underground drain system. A pale object starkly contrasted against the pitch black backdrop. Und what might this be? It's a cloth with suspicious red markings all over it. You acquired a bloody bandage. Gross. Finders keepers. I guess it's all to be found down here. Ha! Up we go. In before someone comes in and is like, what are you doing down there? Okay, out we go. Yes, I guess I'll skip this ahead. Okay, the bandage, it's not the code I found? Of course it could be anyone's, but why would someone discard theirs in a place like that? It seems suspicious to me and is certainly worth checking out. I'll make sure it gets to the right place. I'm not sure if there's anything special about it. About Anna wanting Razor's blood, I mean, she's a scientist, so it's natural she'd be interested in something like that. We'll have to talk to her about it, though. Maybe she has some more details for us. Well done, MetalCore. That gives us some solid points from which we can continue our investigation. Really do appreciate it. Yep, up. I opened up accidentally on my first try? That's pretty good. I just wanted to update you. I still don't have an open spot in the facility for your tests, but I'll be free if you want to cash in your reward. You know I'm busy, so this is your chance for your date if you even still want to go through with it. Take it or leave it. I don't care much either way. In any case, you know where to find me. Guess the choice is mine. Status. Oh look, we have actually impressed her now. Woohoo! Anna, come here. Okay, and just on time. She's not here. We're playing the waiting game. We are going to wait till it's fucking dark. I'm just gonna wait. Oh, fuck. Whoops. Status? Yeah. Take it. No. I want to actually do this. Save? Okay, just for you guys, I will save. Not in auto. Want to. Swiggity smoothy, MetalCore's coming for that booty? Oh, yes, I am. You bitch, sweet ass that I am. Save over my first save. That happens to the best of us. It happens to me all the time. I guess we missed our movie. Can we see the late screening or something? No, that was. Okay, skip! Save before third Anna visit, though? You're going to want to. Well, actually, I do. Now that's the spirit. I'm getting kind of hungry. We'll be having a meal. Well, I have my own dirt. Oh, you're a bad girl. We're going to get the apple. Evolution. You're a wild one. Now treat her like a princess? Okay. Not sure he has to do it anymore? Of course I do. I'm a fucking time traveler. Not bad. Was unusual but fun. More like a queen? Yeah. think you have a point. I haven't been feeling... Okay, here's some more dialogue. You know, I think you have a point. I haven't been feeling like myself lately. There are various reasons for that, but working too much might be one. Today was kind of fun, so maybe I should make the effort to get out every once in a while. Speaking of which, now that our date is officially over, we should talk about your end of the deal. Of course. There is an opening soon where I can fit you in. I'll call you with all the details. I shall be looking forward to that. Status report. Impressed. Guess I can do whatever. We're going to read because we're a fucking egghead. Fine. No. First possibility. Skip. 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 Okay, production facility. Hey, MetalCorp. I didn't even call you about the tests. If character calls you on the phone by themselves, it means they really like you, by the way. You might not want to disappoint them. Yes, I have noticed this. She wants the tea, tests. I have a few questions about the murder of your colleague. Is that so? Okay. Matter of human interest. You could say so. What's in it for me? Hey, I already agreed to your tests. I'm working with the police. Okay. Skipping intensifies. My pleasure. Okay. What I think is hilarious is that MetalCore sounds like my buddy Andy, who was born and raised in Texas. Voice, mannerisms, etc. Basically the same guy besides look or form. Well, small fucking world. Oh, whoops. We're gonna call the police. We're gonna visit the archives. I don't fucking know. Kinda busy. Well, there's nothing I haven't done already, so... I mean, we could play a prank, I guess? No, I'll leave this one for my asshole run. Rummage through the trash. Nothing useful. Copy of the map. It's payday, MetalCore. Oh boy. The tests are ready, the machines are ready, the lab is free. Only one more thing is needed to get this party started, and that would be you. So you better bring your body to me, or else I will have to come get it myself. In which case, I won't be able to guarantee your safety. Oh my. Hope you aren't afraid of needles. Okay, we're gonna save just in case. She's going to go all out, isn't she? Asshole run? Yes, I am going to go on maybe even a few runs with all the different characters where I am just going to be a complete and utter dickhead. Evil ending, including that, yeah? Well, of course we are going to go to Anna. And we are going to give her where he will shoot scaly faces. Well, I wouldn't miss an opportunity to meet you. A glutton for punishment, huh? Not that I mind. Follow me, please. You skip. You're the one that got born? What would that look like anyway? Is that your scientific curiosity shining through? I can approve of that. You didn't answer my question. Well, I'm not going to show you. If you're that curious, you might find the answer in the seedier parts of town. That's mean, MetalCore? I mean, you know, I gotta find out. I'm kinda curious. Your town has seedy parts? Oh, there's a lot you haven't seen yet. I would like to see what this... did I save? Yes, I did. I thought it might have been you. Yes, I saved! Don't worry! Jesus! Whatever. I like keratin, that's because it is. I'll just shut up then. Thank you. How'd I feel about needles? Oh, go ahead and poke me if you need to. I see, I'll make the most of it then. What is it now? Well, it's... You know what? I kind of want to know what she says here. It's like, this is kind of embarrassing. Because I bet she would really like that. Just like, ooh, someone's not very comfortable. Did I save? Yes! Night Sky! Yes, I did! We worry because we care? Oh, yeah, of course. Fuck. No. Well, we usually don't take off this much in front of others. Not even for doctors? Oh, we do, but that doesn't make it any less embarrassing. I don't understand. I mean, I get why you would want to put something on it if it's cold, considering your lack of fur, but to have this compulsion to always have some layers on is a bit strange. It's just a social norm where I come from. As you can probably tell, we don't have a problem showing what we're born with. This will also take a while. I want to have a good reference and show, see how your rates change. Okay, understood? Yes. A human? No. Favorite color maroon? No. Interesting. I've been convicted of any crime? No. Make your knees my ass all the questions negatively? No. Back with the mouse wheel safe, reload and make another choice? Yeah. Make it like that anyone since you arrived? Yes. I see. Have any ulterior motives when you came towards the mouse wheel led to believe? No comment. Do I want to get close enough to examine you? Can or well, sure. That what you're into? Good. Motherfucker. Yes, ma'am. It's kind of hard. How much exercise? A little. Well, I'd rather be looking at some pretty pictures of you instead. Mm-hmm. That's the best you can come up with, seriously. Am I messing up already? Okay, being that rude to everybody? Sorry. You apologize. That's a new one. I don't want to make any excuses, but with a high-pressure job like mine, I don't really get to go out and socialize much. Add some deteriorating circumstance to that, and you get my life. Don't you have any friends? Not really. If you keep skipping grades like I did and were on the fast track in university, you wouldn't really have the time to make or keep any friends either. I think the last time I had a real friend was more than a decade ago. Well, this one goes out to you then, Anna. Redeemed? Yeah, we are still impressed. Okay, good. What happened to that friend? Well... Oh boy, here comes some backstory. Oh boy. Well, we went to the same class after a while. For a while. No, she asked when he came in our world. Am I understanding wrong when I think it means she asked if we came to stab the dragons in the back or something with this question like Maverick does? Honestly, I highly doubt it. I ended up skipping a grade after that year. She found new friends. I didn't. We still met, but those visits became less and less frequent as time went on. I was around 10 years old when her parents prompted me to visit her. She was in the hospital. Apparently had been for some time already. I think I know what's going on. I think that friend got cancer, and that is why she wants to find a cure for it. I didn't know because I hadn't seen her for quite a while at that point. She had contracted some sort of degenerative disease that caused her to gradually lose control of her muscles. Her case was particularly bad. She was already paralyzed from the neck down by the time I went to visit her. Jesus. When I entered your room, I couldn't even pretend to be your friend. Lying in the bed was just a crude image of her former self. It was as if she was already dead. I couldn't bear to see her like that. It scared me. I didn't stay very long. Seeing her like that was... I just told myself I never wanted to end up like her. Dying slowly, painfully, and alone. The feels! That was the last time I saw her. She died a few weeks later. And that's why you became a scientist? Well, not really. I became a scientist because that's apparently what I'm good at. Doesn't make my work any less important, though. Just from what we did here today, we might make a few breakthroughs in several areas. Really? You are a completely different yet stable evolutionary line. There are some things that are similar in our bodies and others that are completely different. Anything that is different and works can tell us something new about biology. All the various species have their own challenges and diseases. It'll come in handy somewhere, I'm sure. And you're doing all of that because of your pure, unselfish heart? Not really, but if I do the brunt of the work, then I deserve to have my name on it. I guess so. Well, I think that's it for the day. You can go if you like. Sure, thanks for having me. My pleasure. We could get together if you want to. Is there even anything left for you to test? Well, I'll have plenty of data for a while, so I guess we'd have to find something else for us to do. I see. Well, maybe that movie? Or something along those lines? Well, I'll leave you to your work then. Mm-hmm. God, I would give her a hug after that. Just like, hey, you okay? Like, that must not be a very comfortable thing to talk about. Did he give her some blood at the beginning in this run? I missed this part. I pretty much always give my blood. Okay, this happens. Okay, I'm gonna let Bryce go in now, just because I want to see what happens. Actually, I'm not sure if this is such a good idea. Chief. Sebastian, what are you doing here? I told you to stay put. Don't go inside, Chief. Why? What's the problem? There is a device on the inside of the front door. I think it might be a trap. I didn't tell you to look inside. I'm sorry, Chief. I just had a feeling that something terrible would happen if I didn't. Oh, clever! Let's just check it out. That was a pretty close call, you know. Too bad Razor wasn't here after all. Guess your intuition was right, Seb. Looks like it. You know, maybe you should show initiative more often. Thank you, Chief. Skip! Okay, we are gonna go to the facility, I guess, because now Anna's here instead of the other dude. When I approached Anna's lab, I saw her sitting on the hallway floor, the door next to her lab wide open. Oh boy. That can't be good. She's too cute not to give her some of your blood? Okay. Hey, Anna. Oh, it's you. What's going on here? The police came and raided the place! What? Why? It's a long story and I'm not going to tell it now. Is it bad? I don't know yet. I'm not sure how they expect me to work in these conditions, considering I get assignments from the council and the police. And then they both turn around and mess up the place as if it's part of their job. It doesn't make sense to me. Someone's gonna hear about this, and there will be consequences, I can tell you that. There will be words. Very strong and stern words. Anyways, what did you want? I'm here to drop this off for you, courtesy of the police. That's what I'm talking about. Mess up my place, then ask for my help. Something isn't right here, and I'll get to the bottom of this. What is this anyway? I'm sorry, it's a bloody bandage for analysis. It's related to the Razor investigation. Alright then, I'll take it. Not for the police department's sake, but for yours. Don't let me hold you up. I'm sure you have places to be. Well, see you then. Yeah, yeah. There isn't anything we haven't done yet, so... I mean, I could visit the guy again. I mean, we've talked to the guy before, so... Okay, this I can skip. I know that much. But not that I don't mind. Not that I mind. Okay, here I'm gonna have to save. Because, well, first of all, you guys told me to. Oh, it's not my status. Oh, my status went down. What the fuck? Why? She was impressed before, but why did it go down? Ipsum is sad, though. I'm confused. Why did my status go down with her? Yeah, she's here. Hey, Anna. Oh, is she crying? Hey. What's going on? You sounded pretty worried on the phone. Worried? If I was worried, it would mean that I was afraid of something that might happen, but I'm way beyond that. I know exactly what's going to happen to me. Oh no, don't tell me. No, don't tell me this is the case. Please don't tell me this isn't. It's over. It's all over. What are you talking about? First they came to my lab, and now they went to my home too. Who did? The police! They raided the place! They had a warrant and everything! I already know that they have all they need to convict me. I'm gonna die in prison. Why? It's because of those tests I did on you. You will die in prison because you looked at my fingernail under the microscope? I'm a bit confused. Why don't you start from the beginning? Alright. Shit, dude. This goes years back and you already know half the story. I was a brilliant mind who had skipped years in school and was on the fast track through university with an incredibly lucrative career in front of me. You wouldn't believe the offers I had based on all my accomplishments. I was still in school and already solving problems that no one had even touched before. I had so many awards lining my shelves that new ones just went straight to the trash. I didn't need them, I just enjoyed the challenge. Besides, I couldn't care less about what some old people thought about my work. As if I needed their approval. I was already more than any of them could have ever dreamed to be. The next problem I was going to tackle was an incurable disease. I started my research, but in an ironic twist of fate, I ended up contracting that very disease myself. I was afraid this was going to be the case. And yes, I've had experience with this. I've actually lost my grandmother to cancer, so... this is going to feel a lot. Shit. Whether someone had not been following health and safety protocols as well as they should have, or if I was just unlucky, I'll never know, but the reality was that I now had a disease that was treatable but not curable. Despite having helped an incredible amount of people with my work, I was now the one who needed help. Yet there was no one who could help me. No one but myself. I was already planning on working on a cure anyway. And what better reason could there be ever be than to doing it to save myself? I told no one about my affliction and set out to do with what many others had failed to do. Any materials I needed to start on my work were easily acquired just by waving my status around. I had free rein over my own lab. I could have even gotten assistance if I wanted to, but I knew they would only be liabilities. I even had a good few leads for ways to combat the disease, although the ones that I chose to pursue was not exactly legal. Not without prior approval by the council. My research was promising though, and while I submitted the paperwork, I knew that these things always moved slowly. Being pushed through the various boards and committees could have taken months. Cryonite and sadness? If not years, depending on how generous they would be. I just couldn't afford to wait that long, as I was working against the clock. So while waiting for the paperwork to be approved, I had already started with my work. I fully expected them to approve it eventually. How could they not, given that I was tackling an incurable disease? The method I was going to use was not necessarily a new one, but it was controversial. It didn't even cross my mind that anyone would object, seeing as I would cure thousands, and if not millions, of future people. But I was younger then, and a little bit more naive than I am now. In the end, my whole project came crashing down in flames. The proposal that I was sure would be approved was ultimately rejected, putting all the work I had already done in jeopardy. I had made good progress at the time too. After the rejection, there was going to be an inspection of my workplace in order to determine the progress I had made on the project, which they had assumed had been within legal bounds and didn't include the controversial things outlined in the paperwork. Of course, that meeting was just going to be a pretense, because I knew there were already rumors going around about what really went on in my lab. In the end, I had very little warning. Thankfully, I managed to dispose of the most egregious evidence before they arrived. They found proof of my wrongdoing, but since they didn't find evidence of how far I had already proceeded, I was able to deny most of their accusations. Using the controversial method when it hadn't been approved was still seen as a very grievous offense, however. I was charged and sentenced harshly, though the sentence was suspended due to their lack of evidence. With all I had done for them, they knew better than to take away my license, and I was able to continue work in other areas, under the condition that it was all within a council-owned facility. Fuck, dude. I see, so I assume that those tests on me were against whatever conditions they set for the suspended sentence? Exactly. Why didn't you just do the things the proper way and waited for the paperwork to clear? Before my paperwork would even get through, you would be long gone. Using you as a test subject would have been a process that the council would have to discuss with humanity. As such, there might have been another trade agreement, and who knows what else. I just didn't have the time. Quite frankly, I don't even know how much longer I have left. This is my death sentence. You thought my test results would help you find a cure? And that's never going to happen now! How did they find out so quickly? It hasn't been that long since I came to your lab. It wasn't just those tests. There was Reza too. But Reza told me he didn't give you any of his blood when you asked for it. Because that's not what I got from him. This is my life we're talking about. Do you think I didn't spend hours on the ground in the hallway of the facility after Reza's first visit, trying to find a stray hair or anything else I could use? Or that when I gave him that first generator, I didn't try to graze his skin just enough so that I could salvage a few skin cells? How did they find out about all this? It was Damien, my assistant! That piece of shit! He was blackmailing me. No, don't tell me. Why? Because he's jealous of me! Jealous of my success! He found out what I was doing with the stuff I could salvage from Reza. I didn't mind giving him what he wanted, though. I just wanted to live. Don't tell me he made her do what I think he did. Because otherwise, I'm going to the morgue and I am going to cut that son of a bitch up. Oh, when he died and the police searched his apartment, they found all the evidence he had on me. And now everything is coming down. I will be punished to the full extent of the law and I will die in prison. My work will forever be tainted. Not that I'll care about that when I'm dead. Do you remember that childhood friend of mine I told you about? I never wanted to end up like her, but it seems not even I can do anything to escape that fate. Maybe I deserve it. No one deserves something like that, dude. I can honestly tell you, I would not even wish that upon the people I despise the most. I would never, ever wish that upon another person, because I know how bad that is. I've seen what it does. And that's why I wouldn't even wish it upon the one I would want the most dead. I wouldn't. Maybe it's my punishment. I have to die like she did, because I left her. I will spend my last days bedridden in a prison cell, and no one will visit me or care. And now Metalcore knows why everyone hates Damien? Yeah. And you know what? With all that data I got from you, I might have actually found a cure. I don't want to cry in front of you. I don't want the attention or the pity. I don't want it. I didn't cry back when I was diagnosed, and I'm sure as heck not going to cry now. I want to tell her. I don't know what it's going to make her do, though. I don't think she'd like it. Well, you have cancer. How do you know that? I saw a treatment plan while I was waiting for you on our date. What? Okay, yeah, this pissed her off. How dare you look into my personal belongings? Hey, I wouldn't have if you didn't keep me waiting. So what? That doesn't give you any right to look into my stuff. It just happened, okay? Tell her is good ending? Well, I did it. I did it then, if that's the case. Now you show your true colors, Metalcore. You are just as duplicitous as our government. They keep talking about how they care about everyone, yet that wasn't what happened to me. It's their backward rules and traditions that now demand that I die. The same rules and traditions that would make them worship you just because of some stupid old legend. You know it and use it to your advantage to arrange this one-sided trade with us. That wasn't me. It doesn't matter if it was you in particular or one of the other humans. You still work for them, don't you? You look into things you shouldn't. Reza does whatever the heck he does nowadays. Save? So we see both endings? I mean, I have saved at the beginning of this chapter, so I can just, you know, go back to that, so it's fine. Why did I even come here today? To have another knife driven into my back? I'm just not sure why I ever expected anything different from you. It's not like that at all. Oh, really? Prove it! Where I come from, we can cure cancer, if you came with me. You can? Are you saying that if I went back with you, if you smuggled me out, that you could cure me? We have the facilities. If we had the power from the generators we asked for, we could. Are you kidding me? Because if you are, I... No, it's the truth. Maybe we could work something out. I'm sure humanity would not object. Or maybe we could just give you the technology or the necessary method. We already have cured cancer, so there's no need for you to die. Why would you do that for me? You know I didn't care about you. I just wanted your blood, your data, just anything that would help me save myself. Well, I would have done the same thing, you know, so scolding you for it would be incredibly hypocritical of me. And that's exactly what I'm going to give you. Why? No one has ever cared about me. People were always willing to use my research. But I was just a machine to churn out results for them. That's what all the awards were for. I admit that I was selfish, always. Yet I did great things. At least that's what everyone kept telling me. You know, after that whole affair back then and the suspended sentence, the rumors about me never stopped. Did they warn you about me? Tell you to stay away? I'm sure they have. Why are you still here? I didn't listen to them, I guess. Just like you. The council, Damien, Remy, they were always sabotaging me. If everyone just left me alone, I wouldn't even need your help. Why couldn't everyone just leave me alone? When they gave me the manager position at the facility, that was just to distract me even more, giving me free rein over the lab so I'd be tempted to do something I shouldn't. How could I not at least try? One of their oh-so-important founding principles is how every individual is important. Well, that's clearly not the case with me. At least they never showed it was. Now I can see just how different you are. You are the only one who came to me willingly and without any ulterior motives. Or did you? Oh, you invited me. I just took that invitation. Just to use you. And you still came back for more. You let me do all those tests on you. Sure, you complained like a pro, but you sat it out for me. Well, I owed it to you. You don't owe me anything anymore. So what? Maybe I won't have to die after all. If you can cure me, I'll give you whatever you want. I know there's politics involved, and I know it may not ever happen. But this is my last straw. My last hope. I'll do what I can. Thank you. Anyway, enough of that. I hope you don't mind me hanging around here. My place still looks like the police raided it. Oh, wait, that's exactly what happened. Do you need help cleaning up? No, I can pay someone to do it later. I just don't want to be there right now. Nice apartment you got here, by the way. Not quite as fancy as mine, but this isn't bad either. I guess the council treats you nicely, huh? Hey, it wasn't my decision. You're such a VIP, aren't you? Well, I can't be that important if your apartment is nicer than this. Besides, after your rhetoric about being wild and all that when we went on our date, I assumed you were just more the type of person who just lives in a hole in the ground. That's not what I said. I told you I can appreciate all kinds of different experiences. I could survive in the wild if I wanted to, though. You want to know what I did on my last vacation? I just started walking in a random direction. I spent a weekend in the wilderness before I came back. Well, that must have been an adventure. I wouldn't be able to do that without tools. I could give you some tips if you'd like. Not sure if I'll ever need them, but I guess they could come in handy. Actually, there's one tip that should take care of everything.
Let's hear it then.
Just be a dragon. Then you've got everything you need and don't have to rely on tools and other stupid stuff. Yeah, that's super helpful. How do you think I'm supposed to do that? Not my problem. Actually, can you tell me about your advances in genetic engineering? Maybe you could make it happen. My personal ones? I was speaking more of your society as a whole, but if you have personal experience, that could also be interesting. We could do so much if we wanted to. Cloning, genetic scrambling, or hybrids of our various different species. Heck, we could even create new species if we wanted to. But that's not going to happen anytime soon. Tampering with genetics is not allowed. Why? Our enlightened society does not see any value in it. Besides, you know about our creation myth, right? The one about a human creating you?
Yeah, that one. It's the only one we have.
Anyway, we are not to tamper with the perfect images after which we created. I think that is pretty much similar to what we have. And what would those be? The belief is that each species was molded for a particular task or a particular role in our society. Really?
Well, some of them aren't even wrong. It suggests certain species should go into certain jobs because of their naturally higher aptitude in those fields. Can you give an example? Well, let's just say that while everyone can join the police force, you'll never be the flyer on duty unless you belong to a species that can fly. That much is a given. I was talking more about if there's any sort of discrimination, for example. You could say so. These structures can be pretty rigid in places, especially where the council is concerned. They really like to employ the members of the various species in their traditional roles. Ironically enough, the perpetual nuisance you know as Remy was a revolutionary case where that didn't happen. In what way? Well, a council aide, particularly one who works in the archives, is usually a member of a species with more dexterous hands. You can't really expect a four-legged species to do that kind of job well. And he doesn't. It's really been a disaster. He's basically become the laughingstock of the whole town. When Remy initially got the position, there was a lot of controversy about the subject. Some liked it, some didn't. I thought that for Emira, politics was a popularity contest. Doing something controversial and divisive like that doesn't really fit that image. Well, she wasn't like that in the beginning. It certainly caused people to remember her, though. And now that people know her, she has changed her attitude quite a bit. It was a good move, because it kept her in the spotlight all the time, and she's using it to gain popularity now. So, she just likes the attention? I don't know why she does it, and frankly, I don't care. You'd have to ask her for yourself, but I doubt she'd tell you. I wouldn't expect honesty from someone like her. Politics always used to be so messy back home. Scandals, arguments, lies, they were everywhere. We do get the occasional scandal from time to time, and of course there's always rumors. Can't really make people stop talking. In a way, I'm glad we don't have all that anymore. Why not? At some point, it just gets tiring. People get loud and argumentative, and those are supposed to be our leaders. That's not something people would like here. If you're a council member who wants to be popular, you don't engage in that kind of behavior. That sounds like a nice change of pace. Not necessarily, since it also leads to reluctant agreements and sweeping issues that should be talked about under the rug. You know what? That doesn't jive with me. They'd like to preserve this fantasy of peace and harmony in our society. For me, it's just so fake. People pretend to be something they aren't to conform, because they don't want to stand out. They become faceless puppets, like drones in a hive or cogs in a machine. What kind of world do we live in where speaking one's mind is seen as something bad? I've never held back. Now, see where that's gotten me. I bet some would argue it would just be easier to conform then. I could never do that, and besides, I don't want to. There's this thing called integrity, and if there's one thing the society needs, that's it. I really agree with you on that, Anna. Now you're starting to sound like a politician. If that's what your politicians sound like, maybe they aren't so bad. Sometimes I just want to walk up to some of ours and shake them until they wake up and accept the truth. Well, what is the truth? I'm a scientist. Truth are facts that are empirically verifiable by science and tests. After all, the tests I do in my job are to find out if assumptions are true or not. I suppose if you ask different people, their definitions of truth would be very different. What's truth to you then? Well, I'd say I share your view, actually. Oh, there aren't nearly enough people like that around here. You do seem to like talking about this kind of stuff, though.
Oh, believe me, I do.
I'm not an ambassador for nothing, you know? You're an ambassador so you can discuss the nature of truth within different cultures? You know, if you ask the wrong kind of person, these kinds of discussions could turn very ugly. I'm certainly here to learn about what you're thinking and how your society works on a deeper level. Of course, I wouldn't just walk up to someone on the street and start talking. Maybe you should be talking with someone in social studies, then, and not me. Not necessarily. Even if someone like that gave their opinion, it's still important to hear the people's voices themselves. Okay, anything else you want to know? How much do you really like me? That's not the kind of question I was expecting. Well, you called me when things went down, and you say you don't really know anyone else. So what? Is it that hard to admit that you like someone? You know me a little by now. You know what I'm like. Whatever you're looking for, you know I'm not that kind of material. Not even as a friend? You want to use emotionally laden words to describe our relationship? We've met a few times and that does it for you? Well, this isn't about me. Before anything happens to either of us, I just want to know. You want me to tell you how I feel about you. Even if something happened between us, you know it's not made to last. You'll go back to your world and I'll probably spend the next few years in prison. Well, you wouldn't like the commitment anyway, would you? True. I wouldn't let something like that hold me back. People don't like me and I don't like people. That's how it has always been. Right now, though, I'd have to say that you're probably the person I hate the least. That's something, I guess. And I also can't deny that you have a certain exotic quality about you. Now you're talking. Oh, but enough about me. If you've put up with me for this long, it can't all just be your own unselfish kindness, can it? Oh, I don't hate you too. I just want to see how she reacts when I say this. I mean, she's probably gonna facepalm like a motherfucker. Oh, looking back, that actually explains a lot. Why else would you follow my every whim? Not that I mind. We both got what we wanted, and now I even kinda like you. Usually people stay away from me after the first date, because that's apparently all it takes. Not for you, I guess. You know, this might be our last opportunity to do something. Why not make it worth it? She just wants your freaky human dick? Is that a yes? Yes. She strode forward, reaching out with a claw before she hooked it into the neckline of my shirt. Aw, she is cute. And rather beautiful in this picture, I have to add. What are you doing? Well, we have to take these off, don't we? Not like that, you'll ruin them. I'll do it. Alright. So fussy. Another free day, yay me. Like I said, I really hate that this game sneaks, just, you know, skips over the romance scenes. Slow down a little bit, BRB, don't want to miss the ending, and no real talk until I'm back. You know, like I said, I really hate that this game just completely skips and looks over the romantic parts. Like, not even, you know, like a small description of what happened. You know, not even a little bit, it's just like, okay, you know, you did the thing. And that's it. You know, next day. Ends with some political talking and some hot stuff. I mean, you don't hear me complaining. Two of my favorite subjects. Empty. Emptied my beer. Guessing we're going to continue on with this stuff. Well, the game is on Steam. It can't go too far, I guess. I mean, even if you just give me, like, you know, a small description, like, we had some real fun, it was real passionate, and that's it. You know, it's, you don't have to explain it in graphic detail, but just don't look over it. You know, it's like, okay, you know, we're gonna get to romance part. There you go, we sort of imply that something happened, and then you just completely look over it. What's in the box? Well, I mean, what is the only thing that can be in the box? My dick, obviously. But you know, that is one of the complaints that I have about the game, is that it completely looks over the romance in this fashion. Which is a real shame because, you know, I've played some other visual novels who had sort of the same thing. But they went into, you know, rather graphic detail. But, you know, they at least, you know, explained something about what happened. You know, it's like, you know, a passionate night or something. You know, this is, you know, like it never happened. Okay, we're going to get some well-deserved rest because there was a lot of this night. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. You might want that back. Chapter 5. Duty. Well, it's up to the fans to explain it in graphic detail, I guess. I guess so. I mean, you guys should really get on that. Developer probably thought people would complain because it's kind of doing stuff with a dragon. Yeah, but it just... It's like... There's a real missed opportunity there. You know, it's still part of the story, you know? We know it happens. Unfortunately, Velvet didn't care about filling these holes as well. I mean, you know, fair game to him, but like I said, that makes the romance especially really lacking in my eyes. We have to be careful with it being released on Steam as well. I mean, we have stuff like, you know, the Sakura game, so, I mean... We probably need the normal mode and the sexy mexi mode. Well, like I said, at least don't skip over it. Big fireworks, who shall I bring? Well, of course, I'm going to bring Anna along. And because you guys like saving so much, I'm going to make a new save game. There you fucking go. I'm gonna go with Anna. So I couldn't fill them? I mean, if you listen to what this guy is writing about, I really find it hard to believe that he doesn't have any experience with romance. It's not zoophilia since she is sentient. Good point. A month of E621 can fix it. That must be her. Hello. Hey, Metalcore. Looks like you're ready to go. Well, it doesn't have to be sexy on a sexy night, but heartfelt romance would be great. Yeah, like I said, you know, at least something. I didn't think you'd want to go to a community event like this one. Anything can be fun with the right company. With an argument like that, we could just stay here. I haven't seen the fireworks in years. With all the crazy shit that's happened to me recently, maybe there'll be a reminder of better days. Is this like the first like swear word that I've heard? Because the language has been rather tame up to this point, you know, and shit is like... That feels new, you know, like... Yeah. Better days? You usually don't talk about yourself like that. Oh, it's because I just don't give a damn anymore. Who cares if you know about me? Who cares if the entire town knows? I certainly don't. These days, I'm just trying to make the most of whatever is left. Alright, let's go then. And you know what I hate? Do we need detailed romance or not? Yeah, sure. And you know what I hate now? I know what's going to happen. She's not going to be able to get back. Because the portal will be sealed off. And it's linked to my biometric data, so... She is still going to end up dying, and that makes me really, really upset. No, she called her assistant a piece of shit, too? Oh, yeah. And that is really upsetting to me. Okay, and we're here again. We basically go here every time. So much for the whole town being out to watch the fireworks. Yeah, I'm not going to those places. I'm kind of a celebrity, you know? Do we need oxygen or not? I mean... Not really. Really? For better or for worse, people know about me. Of course they would, given my intellectual status. Or maybe you just don't want to be seen with me. No, that's not it. Actually, that could be quite fun. It would only be another reason for people to be jealous of me. Oh, I think it's starting. As she wanted you to get the fuck out. Yeah, that's true. Okay. Rocket swallowed. The beautiful fireworks. Oh, and here comes the terrible part. No! Okay, here we go. Really? The fireworks just started. I know where Reza is. We need to stop him. Speak for yourself. This isn't my responsibility. Well, this is much bigger than you. Are you going to help me or not? Alright, just for you. What do you want me to do? Fight him? I'm not sure if that would be such a good idea. I wanted to try talking to him first. If you can buy us some time, maybe I could get help. That would be perfect. He'll be at the portal. Let's go. Oh boy. I really don't think I'm gonna like this ending. Okay, there's Sebastian. The poor bastard. Okay, we've read all this. Okay. Holy fuck. Oh, maybe I can. Suddenly, Maverick and Anna appeared next to me. Oh, I am really not going to like this ending. I am really not. Fuck. I need more beer, but I know I'm gonna need it later. Okay, we're gonna have beer afterwards. You planned this, didn't you? Traitor! I was such a cheap chick. Poor Seb. Champagne, generator, they belong to us. No, they belong to me. Rip Sebby. Can I hear hesitation out of your voice? Despair? Well, yeah, I care about her, you know? Like... Bang! Dead! I really don't want to do this. And she still charges! I'm just like, I feel like I don't deserve these kinds of people, you know? Oh! Maverick was fast, pouncing on Reza before he had a chance to aim at any of us. Wait! No! Yes! He was knocked to the floor and Maverick embedded his teeth into the body before him. Reza was screaming. He aimed at Maverick's head and frantically pulled the trigger twice. The jaw dislodged and Reza aimed his gun in my direction. Out of nowhere, Anna tackled me, shoving us both out of the way just before Reza unloaded the weapon in our direction. She dead? No, shut up! Both of us were seemingly unharmed, and by the time Reza was reloading his gun, Anna was already up again and running towards him. Just as he raised his arm to aim at her, she jumped and collided with him, causing him to miss his target wildly. No! That's gonna hit the generator! Shit! She was on top of him now, raising a hind leg before slitting his throat with one of the large claws at the end of it. Immediately he slumped. Blood gushed from his wound as he helplessly squirmed on the ground and horrible, distorted noises left his severed windpipe. I actually know how that sounds. Someone having his throat slit. Don't ask me from where. I know how that sounds. It's terrible. After a few seconds, his movement stopped and Anna returned to me. Dude, this could be one of the only actual proper good endings. Oh, I'm gonna enjoy this picture. You got what she deserved, bastard. Are you alright? Yeah. We went to check on the others, but both Maverick and the administrator were dead. Fuck, dude. I love happy endings. Yeah, but the portal is still only, you know, aligned with my biometric data, so... In the weeks that followed, the dragons prepared for the comet. Wait a minute! They have both the generators now! I, on the other hand, spent more time with Anna as she opened up about her conditions. When the time came, the dragons executed their plans. And by utilizing the underground building's generators, the comet was ultimately diverted and never hit Earth. Even after they recovered and powers was restored to the portal, I knew that I wouldn't be able to return to my own time as the administrator Izumi had deleted the coordinates I needed to return home when she repaired the portal a while ago. That is exactly what I was afraid of. While she still had her own reasons for doing this, it meant that now my only options were to stay here or use the portal and the coordinates she had entered to travel back in time and return to the day of my arrival in this world. However, I wasn't very concerned about this at the moment, as I spent my time in this world accompanying Anna on her journey. For her help in stopping Reza, she was awarded the highest honor the council could bestow on her, citing her bravery and exceptional service to the community. As a result, the case against her was dropped and she was cleared of all charges.
Yes.
At least she got that. In the months that followed, I was with her during her cancer treatments and could only watch as her condition worsened by the day. You just condemned humanity to never exist? By this point, she was living in a hospice and had become thin and weak as her disease had eroded her both physically and mentally. Well, what did the doctor say? Who cares what the doctors say? I know he sugarcoats everything. It's not going to be long or else I wouldn't even be here. I'm not sure if there's any sensible way to ask this, but... Oh, we're talking about less than a week. Besides, I'm the one dying here, not you. No reason for you to be so upset. She looked away from me as I saw tears welling up in her eyes. And to think that in your world you already had a cure for cancer. How pointlessly tragic. Yet here I am, being what I never wanted to become. But at least I'm not alone. I need a second. Okay, let's just keep going. A few days later, she passed away quietly in her sleep. The council held a funeral in her honor, which I didn't attend. Now that I had been with Anna until the very end, I had a decision to make. I could either stay here, accept this outcome and all its consequences, or by using the portal in Izumi's coordinates, travel back in time and return to the day of my arrival in this world. This way I could get the chance to try again. No doubt it would be a risk to relive this rollercoaster of emotions. After all, I would have to go through all the events and their dangers again, but maybe it would be worth it. That fucking breaks my heart, dude. You know, it is not easy seeing someone you love, you know, decaying like that. Because that's what is happening, you know, their body is just decaying by the day, slowly shutting down. As it eventually just, you know, tears itself apart. Now I saw the saddest ending in the game, I don't know about that, dude. I'll see. And you know, that is... If it's going to be much more impacting, I feel sorry for you. Don't be. There is nothing that can be done. And yeah, it unfortunately happens to a lot of people. And well, I'm not the only one. And you know, I actually experienced it at a rather young age. I think I was around... You know... 12 to 13 at the time, I was only just in high school. Good thing I'm cold-hearted. I mean, I consider myself rather cold-hearted, but, you know, this just... this breaks me. And, you know, I actually had to call the, the ambulance. That is the first and only time I've ever called 911 in my life. Or in my case, 112. You know, I was sitting at home, my, you have seen Anna's Good Ending. Tragic hero. You know, that is actually the first time in my life I've had to call, you know, the alarm number. Because, my first hour of class was dropped. It didn't go through, so I was home at the time. Because we were living with my grandma at that time. That is another long story. And, yeah, I was home then. While I shouldn't have been. You know, I would have been in school already. And, well, my grandma, we already knew she had cancer, you know, and she was already treated. She was already getting treatment for it, you know, chemotherapy. I can't say I've known you before this, but I don't think you're cold-hearted at all. I mean, that's just me being edgy as well, you know. And, you know, she was already, you know, hooked up to oxygen and, you know, had tubes in her neck and everything, you know, like a valve in it for, you know, liquid, because she had, you know, cancer in the... I don't know what you call it, but it was basically some stuff in your neck. And I think they had to use it to like drain liquid or something, I don't know. And you know, she went to the bathroom, which well, you know, she got in, and you know, eventually I was just, you know, minding my own business, being on my laptop in the living room, and she just, you know, I suddenly heard, you know, a thud. And she had collapsed. You know, I immediately got to her side and, you know, asked, you know, hey, the fuck is up? And, well, all she made was this, you know, this sort of groaning, almost gurgling noise, you know, sort of, it's called a stoma? Yeah, it's a stoma, basically. So I basically just, all I knew that I could do was call 911. Well, it was called the alarm number. So I jumped up to the phone, you know, called and was like, hey, something is wrong with my grandmother. She's just collapsed. I don't know what it is. That, you know, come help. And, you know, they sent over an ambulance and they took her away. You know, a few minutes afterwards, my mom came home and, well, That's when I truly started crying. You know, because I was high off my ass on the adrenaline and the rush. And, you know, once it was all over, I just, you know, that all came crashing down. And, you know, and once she came back again, you know, she... my grandmother cried over just, you know, how brave I had been and how quickly I had acted. And, you know, a few weeks later, she decided that, you know, she can't live with it. And, we basically, well, she, oh, what's the term? I forgot. Well, she basically, you know, had herself slept in, for lack of a better term. And, you know, I honestly couldn't bear to be there for that time. You know, we stayed over at some friends of the family's. And, yeah, a few weeks later, her funeral, and, yeah, that's it. And like I said, I was like 13 at the time. So, like, you know, death was, you know, still this really weird concept to me. Like, you know, how can you comprehend something to someone's existence to just, you know, end like that? Euthanasia. Yeah. Sorry, I'm feeling too hard at the moment. And, you know, that's Like I said, that's the first time that I've ever called the alarm number. Only time. But you know, I am somewhat glad that it happened, which feels like a really weird thing to say. But it has helped me deal with some... It has emotionally really matured me, which has helped me a lot in the years that came afterwards. And you know, the worst thing was, you know, she was so active, you know, she was around like 68 or 69 at the time, you know, and she was still, you know, she had a little garden that she would cycle to every, like, you know, every week, which was quite a bit away, by the way. You know, she would do her gardening there. She would always, you know, go grab the groceries. Need a small minute again. Your story touches me. I'm just going to have to keep talking to her because I want to finish this. And, you know, she was alive and kicking. And she was someone I really looked up to. Because despite her age, she was as active as ever. As anyone else would. And, you know, just seeing someone slowly becoming incapable of doing that. Just... That breaks you, and I didn't even get all that I didn't even see that much of it. But like I said, you know, being confined to a bed pretty much permanently, you know, that wasn't her. And she couldn't live with that either. So she decided, you know, I'm gonna go out on my own terms. So yeah, that's how I've had experience with cancer and death in the early years of my life. But like I said, you know, it's an experience that I'm somewhat glad to have, because then you really get to experience the entire cycle, you know, from being born to, you know, maturing and going, you know, eventually dying. But like I said, you know, if there's anything that I am scared, to death of, is something like that happening. Just eventually deteriorating into a state where you can basically do nothing anymore. You know, that is one of the only things that truly terrifies me. You know, death, I mean, you know, your existence ends as far as I know. You know, it's basically just permanent sleep, you know, you will black out and that's it. I mean, go to heaven, go to hell, I don't know. As far as I can tell, you will just, you know, you will stop feeling everything, you know, like before you were born, so you wouldn't even notice. And, you know, I think being trapped in a state where you can't do anything, that is almost a fate worse than death, to be quite honest. And like I said, that is the one thing that I am actually really scared of. That terrifies me to my very core. So I hope that I won't. And if there's any signs that it starts happening, well, I better start preparing then. But I mean, I'm only 19. I mean, I hopefully still have my entire life ahead of me, so I don't think about that too much. But like I said, sometimes I just consider the idea and I just, you know, it terrifies me. It really does. Probably the hardest. I mean, yeah, this, especially something like this, is really confrontational for some people. And you know, I have no problem with that, but I know that a lot of people would not handle this properly. They would probably, you know, fall into a depression afterwards, you know. Like I said, you know, I've dealt with it a long time ago. You know, I've come to terms with it. You know, things live, things get born, they live, they die. That is the circle of life. I know that one day I will be nothing. I will be nothing more than that. And I just hope that before that happens, I can make something out of it. Or at least the most.
I need a beer.
You're not the first player whom I saw broke on that ending. Practically everyone experienced this moment of hopelessness. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense. There is nothing you can do. And I mean, you are given this sliver of hope. I basically only have my grandmother, my half-brother, and my half-sister far as family goes. So yes, I guess it's personal things that make this ending so bad. As for Metalcore, yeah, pretty much. But you know, the developer, I can tell that he knows how to do it really well. And I really appreciate that. You know, that takes talent, that takes skill. And I would almost say that requires you to have gone through the same experiences. And you know, if all of this game has gone off from experience, I mean, I need to go find the fucker then, because this guy, well, I think he'd be the one most in need of a hug. If everything here is based off of experience. And those are the people that really do deserve a break in their life, you know, just to be happy for a little bit. Even if it's the smallest thing. So, I really hope he gets the Remy good ending, though. He really needs to, if he wasn't a guest, I'd tell him how to get it, just because I think he'd feel that one, too. Well, the thing is, I'm going to end up seeing every route regardless, so I'm going to do a Dane's good ending. I'm going to do Bryce's bad ending. I'm going to do Anna's bad ending. I'm going to do a Dane's good ending. I'm going to do Lorem's good ending. And I'm going to go through every route because I want to have the full experience that this game can offer me. Because like I said, this game has managed to break me twice now. And I am really curious to see what's up next. Well, there's something the player character can do. Go to the portal and try for a better outcome. Yeah, but the problem is, in the end, well, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what you do. You just end up, you know, replaying the cycle. And I don't think there's really going to be an end to this game where you will think, you know, I have saved everybody here. Is what I think. Anna deserved this good time with the protagonist. Yeah. She is definitely one of the characters that deserved, you know, at least that small break. And I mean, to be able to give someone that tiny bit of, you know, that last good time, it still happened, even though you can rewind the time, you still remember that. Yeah, and the thing is, you know, the timeline still exists, you know, it just keeps switching into different timelines. So, I mean, you know, it still happened, and it will still continue going. I feel like for most of the characters, the good and bad endings are minor variations of the good most part, and if he hits Remy's bad ending first, which kind of meant to me, his powerful good ending might lack punch. Okay, people are now getting really spoilery. Some art, let me look in general real quick. Holy shit, there's so many. It is, That would give you Lorm's good ending? Okay, good. I pissed her off. Yes, I did. I was just looking through the comments real quick. There's nothing really interesting. But yeah, this game is fucking amazing. Like I said, just to be capable of, you know, making me feel the way that I do. Okay, so well, I guess I can only, you know, chuck one down for it. I mean, I think this is a little bit more than what I would usually have. So, I mean, you want me to chuck the entire bottle or are we going to go like halfway? Because I don't know how much is in the, how much are in the can, so. So, I mean, think with me here. Ah, fuck, I spilled some. Damn it! Ew! Fuck, I have nothing to clean it off with. Hey, you decide. I've made enough decisions today, though, dude. Backseat drinking. Okay, we're just gonna go for the whole bottle then. Fuck it. I played this game too for far more than 30 hours. I mean, I'm probably gonna end up like that too. I mean, we've been streaming for 3.5 hours. And I've already had like 13 hours, so I'm probably on like 16 to 17. Alright, so we're going to chug this one down for Anna and, you know, may she rest in peace. Ask for a Bryce-sized beer? Dude, I will die if you do that. Okay, so we're gonna throw this one down for her. I want you guys to go grab something to drink. Like something to chug down. If it's alcoholic or not, take a shot, whatever. You know, go grab something. Meanwhile, I'll do something else while you guys go do that. You know what? I'll grab something to clean myself off with. So I will be right back. Chair. I got water this time. I mean, like I said, just chug anything you want. So, where's my headset? There it is. I love this game. Oh, yes, I definitely do. Okay, so does everyone have something to chug? Beer time to drink the sorrows away. Requesca in passe, Anna. Yeah. Another because I can't get anything down right now. I guess as I'm going through similar experiences. Dude, my fucking heart goes out to you, bro. It really does. Okay, so I'm going to assume that everyone has their drink of choice ready. I'm going to count down. We're going to start chugging. Okay? Easy enough. We've done it before. All right. 3, 2, 1. To life. empty. That actually felt much easier to chug for some reason. And I spilled some as well. Because I'm a fucking spastic. Ah, you guys are making me an alcoholic. Fucking Jesus. I mean, this one doesn't feel like it has as much of a bite as the canned one does. And I kind of prefer that. Nice! Not leaked onto your head this time? I mean, this is a bottle, so once it's empty, it's empty. You know, in a can, something is always left behind. Alright. So for anyone who's new here, I'm going to stream again tomorrow. Same time, 8 p.m. GMT plus 1, Central European Standard, Central European Time. Well, announcement will be on my channel. Go down into the description. There is our personal Discord server. Tomorrow it's time for Remy. I do not know yet. I think so, though. I think I am somewhat ready for his route now. Because I think he's one of the, I think he's like the last male character left, right? That I haven't played yet. So I am 99% sure gonna do Remy tomorrow. The egghead. Which should be interesting. So yeah, go to the description. There is the unofficial Discord server for the game, which we are all on. But your hair didn't drink. I mean, alcohol's not really good for my hair as far as I know. Plus, this shit gets sticky. So, yeah. There's that Discord server. There is my own personal Discord server, which you can join. I mean, there's nothing really much interesting going on in there, but you know, you can contact me there, chat with me there, chat with other people that watch me. Can be a bit of fun, you know, bring some life into it. So, yeah, thank you all so much for watching. Subscribe, rate, comment, whatever the fuck, I don't really care. I just do it for the lulz. It's the last of the actual romance, so it's just one chapter hangouts. I mean, I still have the other routes to do, so... Okay, so yeah, that's gonna happen tomorrow. Announcement will be up probably in a few minutes because of you know, I'm gonna create a thumbnail while we, you know, do the after talk in on our Discord server. And yeah, we're just gonna do that. So yeah, like I said, if you enjoyed, subscribe, you know, follow me around. All things can be found in the description, and yeah, thank you from the bottom of my heart for watching, and I will see you all fuckers in the next stream. Peace.